All the good looking women sing along. I can't hear y'all.
You don't know, you know.
And since this doesn't fade out, we're just gonna do a hard stop, basically.
Hard stop it, bro.
Yeah, that was a nice intro. That was a fucking, that was solid. I wonder
I had to let that out, bro. I'm sorry.
They're probably not going to notice that the music cutout is just going to go straight through for them. So we're both just going to be like, just looking around at one part, like, what the fuck is that? We are back in this
Welcome back to the Brutal Fucking View. I'm Splich, and this is...
Brute.
Brute. And we're back.
We're back.
Hiatus.
Yes.
It took some time.
Yeah. Are we recording?
Are we in? Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, everything's good. Everything's good. The last two episodes were solo episodes, but we're back. The crew's back.
We're back. The group is back. I had COVID.
Yes.
I was dying.
Where should we start? Should we start with
that? Yeah. Oof.
So that was like 2 or 3 weeks ago. That was three weeks ago.
The first week was COVID week. Yeah.
Okay, and I think I recorded a solo pod because that was right after the Will Smith slap. Dude, we have so much to talk about.
Oh, we didn't talk about the Will Smith?
We haven't been together in mad long.
Bro.
Hold on. So
that dumb bitch.
Let's start very, very beginning. 3 weeks ago, right before the slap, you hit me up. You had COVID.
I got COVID.
Hit me with it.
I told you before, there are two ways it went down. I either got it from a drug dealer or I got it from a massage therapist.
Allegedly.
Alleged, of course.
I got it.
Because I'm bougie. I'm bougie like that, right?
Yep.
I don't know if it's fancier or not or otherwise. But no, I had COVID, bro. Woke up Monday. Sunday was fine. Woke up Monday, dying. Tuesday, Wednesday, dying. Thursday, fine.
Yeah.
Back to normal.
That three day fucking.
It's the 3 day flu, bro.
Yeah.
It's the 3 day flu. But when I mean dying, like I was actually convinced for maybe 12 hours, 8 hours. I was like, I'm probably gonna die.
Yeah. You're like, this could be the end.
This could be the end. Yeah. It was actually real scary, and I was upset because I'm not ready to die. So I got like a symptom of COVID, and I don't know if this is a symptom or just the panic behind it, but crazy anxious. Like laying in bed.
Oh, anxiety. I did not expect that.
And I haven't had anxiety like that in years. I've been keeping it under control for quite a while.
Yep.
But when I got COVID, crazy anxiety. Like I actually thought I was going to die. But no, I'm back. I'm fine. And then
I'm glad.
We don't record that weekend because I'm still contagious.
Yes.
So, you know, you have to wait 5 days from the last day you have a fever.
Yeah.
Which is Wednesday, Thursday.
Right. Even if you said you were fine, I would have been like, nah, we're not potting.
I figure. The week after that, I had a Sweet 16 to go to and organize, so I couldn't come. And then it's something the week after that. I don't remember.
Yeah. So this actually, you've been gone for three technical weeks just because we planned on not having one of them, I think.
The first one.
We just weren't going to. So we had that first week off, which was the lapse. But then the next week, I just recorded a quick 45-minute episode because I wanted to talk about it. So we might as well go in order at this point.
Yeah.
Right after that, the Will Smith shit happened. I think it was that Tuesday.
We're late, bro.
Yeah, we're late.
We're really late.
Well, so is fucking your mom's house, so I don't feel bad. So.
Yeah, that's true because they record everything a month in advance.
Yeah.
So, bro, did you see it? No one watches the Oscars first and foremost, so no one saw it live.
Right. No one fucking saw it live.
No one saw it live. Yeah. It popped up in my feed Monday morning. Like the day that I got COVID, it was the day the Will Smith thing happened.
Right.
So I was like, oh, this is entertainment. I was actually really happy because I was able to just watch countless Will Smith and Jada Smith videos.
Yes. Yeah.
And so, yeah, what are your thoughts?
Well, I mean,
I can go off.
Yeah. So I did talk about it on that solo episode, but I'll tell you what it boils down to for me because I have two sides in this. One, and these are both going to sound a little harsh, but
for sure.
One, Will Smith was acting as a pussy
bitch
and a biatch.
Nigga.
A motherfucking.
A bitch ass.
I guess a pussy is really the best way to put it. There was no reason why he should have reacted that way over such a dumb, stupid fucking joke.
Disrespect, bro.
Now, my other hand.
Misrepresentation.
We have been shitting all over Will Smith for 10 to 15 fucking years. We are way more than ever before. Dude, the Joe Budden podcast, for the first 300 episodes of that podcast, they would shit on Will Smith almost every chance they got.
Why? I actually don't know that.
That aggressive because of shit with Jada Pinkett Smith and how they put the relationship on blast.
She's embarrassing, bro.
Yeah, she's one of the worst human beings
she is
ever.
She embarrasses the fuck out of herself
Yeah.
and embarrasses the fuck out of him, bro.
Yeah. She's, when you look up cunt, She's the picture that shows up, you know, in the dictionary.
She's in the dictionary.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can Google her. She's the first one that shows up when you type the cunt. Yeah, so that's your thought. You think Smith is a cuck?
Yeah.
That's
my opinion, too. I think he's a cuck. And
he's a big time cuck.
He acted like a child, and I think all the consequences that have come to him, he got banned from all Academy Award-winning things for 10 years. Good. I'm glad.
I hope he never makes a movie again.
Yeah, he hasn't made great movies. The thing is, though, I love Will Smith. I think he's a great actor.
I agree.
And I think, I grew up on Fresh Prince, bro. Like,
oh, yeah.
You know what,
dude.
I mean? Like, I know. That was like 10 seasons of fucking one of the best shows of all time, in my opinion.
I agree.
Yeah.
It was.
But yeah, he's a loser.
So Fresh Prince of Bel-Air came out at a time when black representation was really important.
Right.
We had shows like The Cosby Show and
Martin.
Urkel. What Martin. Was Urkel? Family Matters.
Yep, Family Matters.
So, like, it came in an era where black TV was important because it portrayed the black family as regular Americans. And that's the reality of it.
Yeah.
And most Americans didn't think so. So Will Smith was a really big part. That was really deep. I'm so sorry.
We're going to get.
This should not be an intellectual
podcast. We're
going to
go in and out of
this. Bad, dude.
Yeah, we're going to go in and out of it. But
I had a lot of respect for Will Smith. I thought he was a spectacular actor. I respected his humble beginnings.
Yeah.
And I respected the way he represented a black family because that meant a lot for me growing up.
Yeah.
That being said.
Yeah.
Jada Smith is the biggest. Jada Pinkett Smith is the biggest embarrassment.
Yeah.
To that man's identity to exist.
Yes.
She's an embarrassment. And I think she embodies that. I think she personifies that.
Yeah.
And that's what she is. I saw that slap and, bro, I watch it. I'm not going to lie. Maybe watch it 25, 30, maybe 40
I have watched
times.
It a lot. Yeah.
Like maybe even 50. I wouldn't put it past, I've seen it a lot.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I've analyzed it significantly. I've analyzed Chris Rock. I've analyzed Will Smith. I've analyzed Jada Pinkett Smith.
Yep.
Okay. Chris Rock, first of all, has beef with Jada Pinkett.
Yes.
He thinks she's a dumb cunt.
They all actually have had a little bit of beef in the past.
They've all been friends and had beef with each other.
Right, right.
Which implies they've had a relationship that goes up and down.
Yeah.
But I find it interesting that Chris Rock himself, as an identity, has beef with a couple, Will and Jada. Like, they are one team and Chris Rock is another team. And I find that's very strange.
Yeah.
First and foremost. So Chris Rock, he's a comedian. I didn't think he deserved to get slapped like that. I feel like security should have tackled the fuck out of Will Smith.
Why the fuck didn't that happen?
Why the fuck didn't they kick him out immediately?
Why did they let him go on after the show? And when he gave a speech, when he won his Oscar, he got a standing ovation.
He got a standing ovation.
What pieces of shit?
Him. I know.
Dude, if I was Chris Rock, I'd be like, all you were dead to me.
Oh, yeah. You guys are
You're
pieces
all dead
of shit.
To me.
You guys are pieces of shit.
You know?
So Will Smith walked up, sauntered up on stage.
Yeah.
When's the last time we heard that word?
I don't think I've heard it used in a sentence in real life. I think I've only
Will
seen
Smith
it in movies.
Sauntered up on stage.
Yeah.
Nonchalant, you know, walked up to Chris Rock, winded up, put his right foot back and his left foot forward and his right shoulder back, left shoulder forward, bro. Fucking spun three times. You know, he did the spinning tornado to like charge it up and smack the fucking shit out of Chris Rock.
Hard fucking smack, dude.
And you know what Chris Rock did?
He ate it.
He ate the fuck out of that.
He fucking ate it, dude.
He ate that shit like a man. And he didn't get emotional, bro.
Bro.
He was like Will Smith. He was in awe.
He needs to be commended for that.
He needs a purple heart.
He does.
He needs a purple heart for that shit, bro.
Yeah, bro. He had his hands behind his back, leaning into the slap, and didn't get dropped.
That man's a king.
Will Smith is like 220, I'd say. You know, he's 6-something. He's a muscular dude. Like,
if Ricky Gervais was ripping into Jada Pinkett Smith,
yeah,
Will Smith wouldn't have gone off.
He wouldn't have done fucking anything.
And I'm not even saying Ricky Gervais is a big man, but he's bigger than Chris Rock.
Yeah. No,
and
it's because it was Chris Rock. It's
because it was Chris Rock.
Yeah. He knew he could pick on Chris Rock. He knew that he could get away with that.
100%.
Yeah.
It was embarrassment. So then you see the clip where Chris Rock makes the joke and Will Smith laughs and Jada shakes her head.
Right.
But Will Smith is laughing.
Yeah.
So what the fuck?
Yeah. Hypocrite.
Hypocrite.
And
so,
not to mention, and this is where I'm going to start getting mean, alopecia ain't a fucking disease like that, you dumb bitch.
It isn't,
you know?
That vivid.
It's not as big as she's putting it out to be. I don't want to get too mean.
And, you know, the issue is too, And I really dislike Jada, but she's gorgeous.
Yeah, she is.
She's so gorgeous. Like, she has a spectacular face.
Like, bald, too, you know? Like, even without a weave or anything, she's gorgeous.
I think she looks better bald than she did otherwise.
Exactly.
If you ask me, I think she looked better bald than she did when she had hair.
Yeah.
Personally. So, whatever. Krill Smith. Can we call him Krill?
Why not at this point?
Because he's Krill a fucking Smith. Krill.
He's a
like,
Krill.
Krill like go up and they tentatively touch, but they run away. They're little bitches.
Isn't that food for whales?
Yeah, Krill. Krill. Yeah. They travel in schools for power because they look big.
The followers.
Yeah, he wants to look big and he's a big fucking tough guy, but he's a big weenie.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, Krill Smith.
So Krill Smith.
I like it.
All right, so Krill fucking Smith.
Yeah.
All right. That came out of fucking nowhere. I don't even remember where I was going. So yeah, yeah. No. Chris Rock makes a joke. Krill Smith is laughing. Jada is like, bro, what the fuck? Why are you laughing? Yeah. You know, Jada looked at him and was like, you just going to let him talk about me like that?
Yeah.
And Will Smith and Krill.
Yeah.
He was like, I know what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
I'm going to be a big man. This is going to look real cool. I'm going to go and do this. And I'm going to earn my wife's respect. She's going to stop fucking other men, finally. She's finally going to suck my dick.
Yeah.
You know?
He's hardcore whipped.
He's like, maybe if I do this tonight, Jada won't fuck Jaden's friends.
Maybe she'll kiss me on the penis, you know?
Maybe she won't have a gangbang with Jaden Smith's friends.
Yeah. So,
you know
all the August
from high school.
August Alsine, all that shit, that whole story.
The what?
Her and August Alsine, how they fucked, and
she
admitted
it. She fucked a million guys, yeah.
So that was the one where she admitted it on camera when they were at that table interview together, and Will Smith looked like he was crying, like,
bro,
3 years ago.
And she's like, and you know what she fucking said afterward?
Yeah.
But it was kind of fun.
Yeah. It was kind of fun. And then we have a relationship like this, even though he's never done that, according to him. And also that she released after this slap. I felt pressured to marry him. I never actually wanted to marry him. It was just, I was young and in Hollywood because I just did The Matrix at the time.
She was like, in The Matrix?
I never fucking knew that either. Oh. I was like, yeah, well, you weren't memorable.
You know, she just fucked Tupac?
Yes. So this is what I mean. Everyone's been shitting on Will Smith for a decade for this shit. Like, you fucking cuck. Like, she's doing all this in front of you. She's openly saying it. Yeah. And you're a bitch about it.
Bitch,
and then Will Smith finally does something about it. Obviously, it was the dumbest thing he could have done. But I'm just, that was my other hand doing it.
He should have smacked the shit out of her.
Exactly.
He should have smacked the shit out of Jada in front of everybody. Everyone would have been like, fucking finally, dude.
We're not advocating this, but
no.
Yes.
I'm advocating. I'm advocating. You listen to me. I'm not advocating.
This is the new YouTube short.
I'm not advocating violence against women. No. I'm advocating violence against Jada Pinkett Smith.
Yeah, because she's a bitch.
If Will's a Krill, what's Jada?
I'm gonna stick with cunt, dude. I'm sorry.
It's
a little okay. Let's say she's a. This is gonna really. I don't know why this came to my head. She's a basketball hoop.
She's a cicada.
Because the whole team scores on her.
Scores on her?
Yeah. Dunking.
Yeah, they dunk. Balls. They're hooping in that shit, hooping, bro.
Dunking.
They fucking dump between the legs,
between
around
the
shoulder, pass to the boy.
Dude,
he passes
alley-oop
it back, spits in that shit, boom, dunk.
Yeah. So that's the, for some
break
reason,
break the
came
backboard,
to my head.
Bro.
Yeah.
The glass shatters, bro.
Right. She's the scooter that belonged to no one in the neighborhood.
And
everyone
then you know what she does?
It,
and then she gets gangbang, bro.
Yeah.
Train ran.
The whole team.
For 6 hours in the rain.
Till the backboard
on a
breaks.
Beach. Pebbles. She ain't got no sandals. She has bruises on the ass.
Facts.
Because she's over there laying on the rocks.
Yes. Yes.
Getting pounded.
Yeah. So the basketball hoop.
And the guys, they get up for a drink of water because they're tired. She goes, can I get a drink of water? And tell her to sit the fuck back down.
Yeah.
That's what Jada is.
Right.
And
right.
then she goes home and she shits on Will Smith.
Yeah. And then she uses him.
She goes home to one of the most prolific men on the planet.
One of the most successful black actors ever.
Ever to exist.
Ever.
Iconic.
Yeah.
Memeable.
Yeah. So I was thinking
rich,
about this.
Handsome.
We don't have to go too aggressive on her, but.
And she sucks another nigga's dick.
She is top two or top three females, worst females of all time for me. You know who number one is? And this is what I was going to start off with this episode.
Who?
Amber Heard. Do you know the shit between her and Johnny Depp?
Yeah.
The whole abusive shit that's
been
going on.
I've been reading up on it a little bit. I don't know enough to form an opinion, so I'm gonna tread very carefully here.
So this is where I went really aggressive on her last week, and I was like, all right, in the same sentence last week, I was like, I can't say this so aggressively. I don't fucking know anything for sure. I'm just going aggressive and passionate. However, the new court case is coming again. It's happening currently.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm paying attention to it, and it's making me fucking sick. I won't go any further than this, and you're going to be so shocked when you hear what I say. She cut Johnny Depp's finger off. And she's saying that he did it himself.
Now, I'm going to ask you a question, and you're going to think it's fucked up. What finger was it?
I don't know. You just see him holding.
If it's the pinky, Love is love.
Love is love?
Yeah.
So the pinky's
listen,
fine.
Listen, man. If it's the pinky, you know what I mean?
But out of everything I could have just said about this court case.
Yeah, man.
How is that?
They're young and they're in love, bro.
Yeah.
I mean, she's sucking his dick. She's sucking other people's dick.
Yeah. Well, the only reason I got so.
If it's an index finger.
It looked like it was one of the important ones.
If it's one of the fingering fingers.
Yeah.
The middle of their index.
Yeah.
The important two.
What if it was a thumb?
Oh, then she's a bitch.
That would be hard.
No, that's taboo. I didn't even bring up the thumb because it's too off limits for her.
That'd be real dark.
Yeah.
Yeah,
a little bit of the pinky, bro.
Yeah.
Love is love, bro.
I was just flabbergasted at the fucking... I literally read the headline. It's like Johnny Depp's missing finger in the most recent court case. I'm like, okay, hold on. I got to look at it now because it's a cut off finger. And like it literally is like his team is like, why the fuck would he cut his own finger off? Like really think about that.
Well, he could. I mean, they're both kind of crazy. I also, and
I don't know.
I read this title, and again, it's just, and this is why I shouldn't even open my mouth.
Right.
But I read a title that said the couple's therapist for the both of them said there was mutual abuse. That's what the title said.
I actually agree with that too. I think they both are abusive to each other.
I believe that.
I think they both like the drama to an extent too, which is dangerous.
people, yeah.
They're very famous.
You're going to hate me, bro. Is Coachella live right now? Is Coachella this weekend?
Yeah.
Can we press on that?
Sure. Yeah.
Can we catch a live stream? So we're on Google right now, and there's a little tag that says, watch Coachella live.
No, we can't stream any of this.
Oh, no.
Yeah, this is extremely illegal to stream it.
Oh, it's Coachella, right?
Yeah.
This is protected, huh?
This is technically on national TV right now, isn't it?
Maybe.
I'm pretty sure they're aired on TV as
well. Who goes to Coachella? People that go to Coachella are...
I think it's rappers, right?
It's white kids that got money with their parents.
Oh, you mean the audience?
The audience, yeah.
Oh.
Because who the fuck goes to Coachella?
I didn't
unless,
even
unless
think
if
of
the
that.
Lineup is fire, I get that. But who goes to the fucking Coachella? It's just white kids that are living in the past, bro.
Tyler, the Creator fans?
I'm a Tyler, the Creator fan. So.
But you know his fan base is apparently like 80% white people.
Oh, I know that.
He got like real shit on recently for it. I was like, wow, that. I mean, I'm not surprised, to be honest.
I'm not surprised either. But you know, Tyler, the Creator's music has to do with emotion and sexuality. And that's something that the black community just isn't.
They're not like as in tuned with as in tuned almost, with it. I would say.
Yeah, and that's, it's unfortunate, but
it
this is.
True. Yeah.
You know, so I
do.
It is what it is.
Let's just stay on this, you know? I mean, we're going to be all over the place, but I listened to Tyler, the Creator. Because he won an Oscar at the Oscars.
Yeah.
Which, you know,
he won it for the rap album, Call Me If You Get Lost, right?
So immediately following that, I listened to the entire album from start to finish.
It's a very all over the place album.
I did not like it, dude.
Yeah.
I didn't. Like, it. Yeah. I mean, honestly, I actually liked the songs individually, but as a project, it was not good.
If you're starting with Call Me If You Get Lost, you're going to be lost.
Well,
you have to start 3-4 albums ago.
So that's what I'm thinking. Like, the album that
you, have to start
you told me to listen
bomb.
To, I loved it.
Great.
And I didn't like it when I first listened to it. Mm-hmm. I listened to that album again, and I was like, this is fucking great. This is amazing.
Wait, which one? Flower Boy?
I listened
Igor.
To... I already listened to Igor before, and it was mixed feelings about it because
love
I was so
Igor.
Used to Yonkers and shit, you know? Like, I was the old fan.
Oh, yeah, that's completely different.
So I had to really get myself into the new shit, but Igor I thought was good. Cherry Bomb I thought was really good.
That's like 2010.
I think that one I like more than... Oh, that's probably why then.
Yeah,
And then exactly. Flower Boy I didn't listen to much, but I wanted to listen to the one that won an Oscar.
Yeah.
And I was like, this one rap album? Really? Like,
it's because the progression of Tyler, the Creator's music is so significant. He's incomparable to what he used to be. And the project, Call Me If You Get Lost, it's a cohesive project, but I don't think – it's not like other rap albums where if you listen to an artist, it's going to be one theme – to an extent, maybe with a couple, a little bit of variation.
Yeah.
But for the most part, the whole album has a main theme and it follows that theme. Tyler, the Creator, does not do that. If you listen, there's a song on his, excuse me, there's a song I really like on the album. I'm going to pull it up. I think it's Juggernaut.
Yes. Yeah.
Juggernaut.
I listened to it recently.
Fire, bro.
Yeah.
I think it has like a Lil Uzi or Lil Vert.
Definitely has a feature on it. I can't.
It has a feature. That song is a vibe.
Yeah.
And I got to pull it up. Lil Uzi Vert and Pharrell. That's fire. That's a bop. But if you listen to Sweet, I Thought You Wanted to Dance, which is only three songs or four songs before it, that's a love song.
Well, so
with a completely different tempo beat.
I kind of like that song, though. I kind of liked the songs that weren't that rappity on the album. It's the ones where he rapped on them. Like, he has terrible fucking lyrics on them. That's what got me upset.
You think so?
It is, yeah. I actually didn't mind, like, even the story to the album. I was like, this is put together well. His writing was poor. That's what got me. I didn't like the writing.
The thing about his writing is he's not writing the individual lyrics to be hard. Every song has a different idea behind it. So if you don't like one song and you're like, these lyrics are trash, maybe that's a song that he wrote in a perspective from someone he hates looking at himself in the past. Like, you're... It's because, and you're like, dude, these lyrics are ass. But if you really analyze the entire project, it's a different time frame,
well,
perspective,
yeah,
thought process, ideas.
Yeah,
themes.
But that's not what I mean.
I believe so.
So there's a whole, everything you just said, I love about it. It's mm-hmm. the bars that don't apply to anything. He has random punchlines in there that, and I fucking wrote one down, but I can't remember,
man,
it now.
Come on,
dude,
bro.
There's a punchline in this fucking album that's so bad and has been said so many fucking times before.
It?
I can't think of it now,
dude,
of course.
You can't do that to me.
I know.
You can't.
I wrote
you
it down
do
somewhere
that,
too. I could probably look for it. It might be in my room, but it was just a bar,
bro,
that I've heard done again by Lil Wayne in 05. Like, I heard it seven times better before that. And it was that type of stuff that I heard a few times. All the stuff that was not... The metaphor stuff, the stuff telling stories, loved it. Loved it. The stuff where he just is rapping, you know? That's the stuff like, round my waist like a hula hoop. That type of shit. Like, that. It was ass. It was like he wasn't trying.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
I loved every good part, but...
Like, there's just shit that I don't know how else to explain it that I've heard before. It's lazy writing, in my opinion.
I
and I'm a big writer, so.
You hurt me, bro. You hurt me so bad.
Well, I'll say this.
When you say Tyler, the Creator, has lazy writing, you just don't understand it.
See, no, because it's not something relative to the song. It's just a random punchline.
It's there.
Tyler, it's a random.
Does not have random punchlines.
Yeah, you don't know,
bro.
Tyler, the Creator, then.
Bro, not anymore, bro. I'm telling you. I get it. I understand. I get where you're coming from. I get your opinion. I value your opinion.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to pull up a lyric that looks really fucking done that I can like analyze. Hold on.
I want to say it was in the first 7 to 10 songs on the album. It was in the first, it wasn't the first one or two. I can't remember, but there was one particular bar that stuck out so bad that I was like, oh God.
Man.
I will look for it at one point, but I don't want to dwell on it. But
oh, man.
So I'll say this, in Cherry Bomb, all the other shit, not Cherry Bomb, Flower Boy, Igor, the songs, the story, the love portions of it, amazing. That writing is beautiful. It's unorthodox. Sometimes it doesn't sound like it makes sense, but it's fucking Tyler, the Creator. It connects.
Did you know that Tyler, the Creator, is Flower Boy? Takes place inside of a car.
I heard that. I don't know what that meant. What do you mean by that? I've heard someone else reference this too.
Let's play this. Let's play. And
we can't play it on the pod.
Okay, well, I'll play it. We'll listen.
We'll do it.
So I am going to play the first 15 seconds of Forward, which is the first song of Flower Boy.
So if you want to listen to it, just pull it up. We're going to cut right to it after.
We're going to cut right to it afterward. I'm going to pull this up because I just want to show you how small these things are that connect, okay? So I'm going to play for you just the first couple seconds, and I'm going to break down a little bit. What do you hear? Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom. It's just like
I thought you meant as a word. I'm like,
no, like it's just a melody, bro. Does that sound familiar?
Yeah.
What is it?
I don't know. It sounds familiar, though.
When you go in those classic 05s, 07, 08s, 02 Civics, those cars, old school cars.
That's so smart.
That you put the key in the and it starts beeping.
Yeah, bro. That immediately clicked when you said the Civic.
You just put the key in. You didn't start it. So this song, he hasn't started the car yet.
Okay.
So that's all I want to show you. I have 5 seconds, bro. And when you tell me he drops things like that, don't matter. It's like,
now, dude,
it all
okay.
does.
I'm going to look at the, I'm going to find the bar then. I'm going to find the bar then. I'm going
to
show you.
I have to listen to
it
more.
Because once you hear it, you're going to be like, oh, fuck, you're right. Because okay. It really is. It's just a throwaway. And artists do this all the time. I do, like, oh my God. Like,
a stupid little throwaway.
Of course, yeah, you know? Yeah, yeah. It's just a four bar throwaway, you know? I'm running on the game like a treadmill. That's a bar, and it's a throwaway. You know? It doesn't really have anything to do with anything.
But what's important is, like, what about the lyric before?
Exactly,
that?
Well, I know.
What if he's like,
well, dude, but
running in my life. Not going anywhere.
Of course. And then it has meaning to it.
Okay, now we get it. You're running on a treadmill. You're not going anywhere.
But you know I'm listening for that shit, dude.
I know.
You know I'm listening intently.
That's why I want to hate, but I can't. Because I know you. I'm like, if anybody knows music, it's John.
Yeah.
All right, let's, bro. I know.
I was going to say, we're going to go off.
I'm so sorry, guys.
Well, I do.
I'm a big Tyler, the Creator fan.
I want to wrap up a few other things with this because, God, there was so much that happened. But in the Oscars, right? Samuel Jackson won his first fucking Oscar.
Yeah.
Why has he not got like 50 fucking Oscars before? Like, he should have gotten an Oscar for Pulp Fiction in 2000, dude. Like,
I mean, he's black.
Good point. Yep. Denzel Washington had Oscars, right?
I don't know.
So I was thinking about it because someone else said, like, Will Smith's not even that great of an actor. And they're like, well,
he's
no, he is good. And then I was like, well, is he like one in the top of black actors?
I'd say so.
There's a lot, dude. Morgan Freeman,
Denzel Washington. You right. already said Samuel L. Jackson.
Right. Lawrence Fishburne, better in my opinion.
Yeah, I got honestly. There's a one that I fucking his name. I can't. This is gonna bother me. He's in the Avengers. Don Cheadle.
Better in my opinion.
Love
again.
Don Cheadle.
So I
amazing
already
in everything.
That's
bro.
Already five better than Will Smith in my opinion.
I agree.
You know what I mean?
Agree.
Like,
I agree.
So when people started arguing that, I'm like, I'm not going to butt in because I'm white. I wasn't going to go in that argument.
But,
I already was like,
I guess
Jamie Foxx, I think, is fucking
Jamie Foxx.
Better than Will Smith. Fire.
His roles are more impactful because
yes.
he doesn't act that often.
Yes, right.
So I think his roles are more impactful.
Yeah.
No, dude, I think I'd agree.
Yeah.
I think of those old school black actors that just don't act anymore.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Just to go
shit,
back.
Even Tyler Perry.
Real quick. Oh my God. Tyler Perry might even be a little. Will Smith has more iconic roles than Tyler Perry.
He's a comedic actor.
Yeah, I think it's more.
Comedic actors are very difficult to scale because,
right.
especially like, you remember Gail the Snail? Always Sunny?
Of course, yeah.
She's a real actor.
Yeah, and she's hilarious.
It's really hard for me to see her in other shit because all I see is Gail the Snail.
Because she played that role
She played that role
well.
So fucking good.
Like a little too well.
A little. Like, it's like going full retard, like they say in Tropic Thunder. Never go full. Like,
never go full retard.
Like Simple Jack, he calls
yeah,
him something
Simple
like that?
Jack, yeah. yeah.
What a spectacular movie that was.
Amazing fucking movie.
Fucking
Robert Downey Jr. is probably a better black actor than Will Smith.
Robert Downey Jr. did an amazing job as a black actor.
You know?
He did really fucking good.
He
was a white guy playing a black guy in a movie played by a white guy. And it was actually like really good.
Really,
that's how they skirted the blackface.
Yeah.
Really well. I'm like, wow.
They made it a joke of people doing blackface, but it's like, oh,
they made the joke within a joke within a movie.
Yeah.
And then you're like, I think that's enough layers. I could separate.
Yeah.
Like, I'm pretty good. Yeah, that's pretty spectacular.
That was hilarious.
fuck. All right. Let's not talk about movies and shit because we'll
okay.
stay here forever. You want to talk about this bullshit?
Well, we can, but I have one other thing I want to touch
right before.
Donda should have won Album of the Year, right?
Yeah, didn't it? He won an Oscar for it. Didn't he win something for it? Or Grammy? My bad.
It was like Best Christian Album, I think.
I don't know. Maybe
I remember him winning some Christian thing, which I thought
that was a while ago. That was
is that with people making fun
Jesus
of
Jesus is King?
Okay, maybe people were just shitting on it on Twitter again.
That was a while ago.
Blow up.
He
again.
Did one. He won a Grammy for a specific song. I think it was Moon. A Hurricane. I think it was Hurricane.
He did. I did see that.
It was
yeah,
for Hurricane.
But still, I mean, Donda as a whole versus don't
call me if you get lost.
Don't call me if you get lost.
I mean. Here's the thing. I said Donda hits hard. There are some tracks in that, but I can skip.
Exactly.
But
I could probably listen to Tyler's album.
You think you can
bump no, I don't know.
Donda?
Actually, yeah.
Donda hits, bro.
Donda is, yes,
when's
smacks.
The last time you listened to Donda?
Recently. I have it in my playlist. So.
Have you listened to Donda 2?
I did, but
it's on YouTube.
It kind of threw me off.
It's fire.
Because I thought it sounded very similar on some of the songs. It did. I was like,
but that's why it's Donda too.
Yeah, right, right, right.
Otherwise, it would be its own project. Yeah. Which is why when I heard that it was similar, I'm like, this is okay.
Yeah,
I actually didn't mind it.
Right. Like side B, basically, which is nice.
That's exactly what it's supposed to be. Yeah. It's supposed to be side B to Donda.
Yeah.
Which Donda's his mother, and the fact that he's trying to honor his mother, a woman in his life that's important. Well, yeah. Kanye has a problem with a woman in his life.
Yeah.
Which is evident.
Yeah.
I saw this video on Instagram okay. where Kim Kardashian went to Six Flags or like Disneyland, and she's shutting down whole rides to ride, bro. Like she went on the teacup ride. There's a line like 2 hours long. She skips everybody. They clear the entire ride. There are a dozen cups unclaimed, and she does the entire ride twice.
By herself.
And her family. Dumb. And the people, and there are people recording like, what the fuck? If I were there, I would have booed the fuck out.
Oh, hell.
You fucking suck.
Yeah.
What? You and your whole family shit. You shit, dude. You guys she'd be like, fucking what? Suck, bro.
Yeah.
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 Dude.
100%.
And I get it. You got money. You're going to splurge. Yeah. I get it. But it's one thing on a busy day to shut down a ride and not occupy. It's one thing to skip the line.
Yeah.
I get if you skip the line and jump on the ride with your family, you paid $4,000 for that ticket. I'm not that mad.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Right.
But it's not to shut down the whole ride?
Yeah, so no one else can enjoy it?
No, for 15 minutes,
get the
bro.
Fuck out of here.
The fucking bro, there's this family that was walking like, dude, the show was like 30 minutes they're waiting.
Yeah.
Just the fucking Kim Kardashian and her bitch-ass family to ride the teacup ride right. at Disneyland.
You know they have like 12 security escorting every part of their family.
Oh, they had I'm pretty sure they had security waiting there.
But, yeah. You know who else I heard does that? Bro. Which I was actually like, at first I was like, what? I couldn't see that. And then I was like, well, yeah. Eminem, I've heard is someone who shuts down streets when he walks through.
Oh, really?
Like it's bad.
But he's kind of gang affiliated though.
And
so I kind
of. He has a lot of people that deeply hate him.
Deeply hate him. Yeah.
Like it's not just like a regular hate, right. You know? Like a lot of people actually deeply hate Kanye too. That he's another one, but. It's for different reasons, I would say, you know, but yeah, Eminem has like some like, you know, yeah.
I'm not going to say the gang affiliation is justification to shut down a whole street. I don't know. And yeah. I also don't know the extent of shutting it. Like maybe he shut down the side of the road or maybe like just so that way no one's walking up to him like a stranger and stabbing him in the back. Like,
yeah.
I don't know.
Right.
I understand that. But Kim Kardashian?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like, it's like, who fucking, yeah.
Like, all you need is a security team, four black guys, two black yeah. guys, big, brawling, and no one's going to come close.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, people are going to try to stop him. That being said, speaking on Kim, because I have Kim hate.
I do,
and too. And I never had Kim hate until her and Kanye broke up, but now I got Kim hate. I saw a video where one of Kim and Kanye's sons or daughters, I don't remember which, was playing Roblox on his iPad and came across an ad for Kim Kardashian's sex tape.
I fucking saw this.
And she was she was crying.
Yeah, this is on their new show apparently.
Out, which, who gives a fuck
yeah.
about their new show?
But why would they put this on their show if it wasn't because for attention?
It's clout,
you know what I mean? Like, it's for attention.
Clout,
yeah.
Like the mom, like the son finding a sex tape of your mother, that's not fucking funny.
Yeah.
That's not cute.
At all.
That's not quirky.
Right.
That's fucking embarrassing.
Yeah.
That's trauma for the son.
That's like mental peace. Like that is trauma. It's really deep rooted trauma.
Trauma, dude. And they aired it. Like that's private as fuck.
That's what I mean. Like the fact they just throw this shit. It's a fucking Hulu show now. It's like, are you fucking kidding me? Like you guys are disgusting. You exploit your own family.
My ex used to watch this shit.
Yeah, my fucking exes did too.
Yeah, and I never understood it. Like I really didn't. Like those people are garbage people.
Yeah,
I just never got it.
Yeah,
but
horrible humans.
Horrible, but whatever. Yeah, what are you gonna do, bro? It's just a pinky, bro. Whatever.
It's just a pinky. Yeah, as long as it ain't a thumb.
Krill Smith.
Right.
Whatever.
In the basketball hoop.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should shit on some Mormons. We should get.
You
want to
shit on some fucking Mormons?
Yeah. I don't even know if it's Mormons.
All right, we're back with our popular segment. It's called Mormon time.
Time to shit on some Mormons.
Mormons. So, back with our Mormon. That's right. I did that fucking sound effect without the thing. It's Mormon time, our classic popular segment, and we're going to shit on some Mormons. So why don't you
give some backstory? I'll give a little bit of backstory. So I come home from work actually about 3 weeks ago. This was around when you got COVID.
And you got $1 million.
And I got $1 million bucks. You found a million fucking bucks, I flipped the fuck out.
You were ecstatic.
Rightfully so.
It was on your doorstep. There's $1 million. Or is it in your mailbox?
And then I started.
If it's in your mailbox, that's illegal.
It wasn't. So this is actually what pissed everyone off. So my whole fucking apartment had these sitting in front of their doorstep.
Oh, shit.
And when it was sitting like this, it was taped. So it looked like a stack of money.
Yeah.
So in order for these fucking desperate religious pieces of shit, they had to fucking put a makeshift fake ass money cover, and they turned it into their little Bible. Yep. And this is literally 104 pages for Christians, so it's apparently Christian-related. Fucking excuse of a religion. And let's just read one fucking piece out of it.
You're going to read the fucking Bible, my boy?
Just one fucking thing, okay?
Oh, my God.
Let's see. The discerner of hearts, John 2. Now, when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover during the feast, many believed in his name when they saw the signs which he died. But Jesus did not commit himself to them. Instead, he knew all men and had no need that anyone should ever testify of a man, for what he knew was man.
You know what's crazy about that?
Yeah, what's crazy?
You know what's crazy? Yeah. I tuned out.
Yeah, you know what?
You put me in church mode. I haven't been to church since I was a kid.
You know what else?
I'm 25.
Is crazy about this? This?
10 years.
Four fucking sentence thing just literally said, don't question Jesus. That was the whole point of that four sentence thing.
I didn't even hear that. You put me in church mode. I actually, I'm not even joking. I didn't hear a word you just said.
I'm glad that it helps you tune out like this. So
I think I should start listening to a Bible audiobook to go to sleep. Because that's actually kind of crazy.
Good idea.
Because I actually really tuned out during that.
That's fucking genius. For white noise to go to sleep.
Just Bible.
Bible talk.
Bible talk.
Yeah. Someone reading this fucking shit.
Yeah.
This is so
shitty that they...
I hate this so much.
They printed... I know we said it already, but they printed out this stupid fake... But convincing looking enough, just enough to get your attention, $1 million bill book, put in front of your door, and it's a fucking Bible. Pieces of shit.
Can we see the church?
Can we call out their fucked up little bitch ass?
Call out all the fucking shit on these.
All right, listen.
Every person
there. Lifeway, Proclaiming Jesus, Lifeway Church...
I'm just going to put them out there. Just Lifeway Church.
They got an address? We can send them hate mail. Of course. Put it out there. They're making it public.
All right. Yeah. You can go to lifewaychurch.net.
Yep.
You can call them at 603-845-6601.
Yeah.
Or you can send the mail at P.O. Box 233 East Derry, New Hampshire, 03041.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Give them a call. Let them know how shitty they are.
Yeah.
Let them know this is awful and disgusting. Let them know I don't give a fuck.
Yes.
Stay away from my door.
Right.
Don't knock.
Don't fucking come here.
Don't bother me.
You know what my question is? How the fuck did they get in? How did they get in?
They showed up to the door and they buzzed everything.
They pushed everything until one person let them in. Pieces of shit.
And then they walked up and down dropping these on every door.
Yeah. Don't force your fucking religion on me. I fucking hate that shit. Don't force anything, you know?
This is garbage.
I want to call this fucking number. Can we call it?
You want to call it?
Yeah. I can't put it on speakerphone on my phone.
I'll do it on mine.
You want to?
I'll do it on mine. Yep. I'm down. I'm angry. I'm gonna be like, why'd you guys? This is really shitty what you guys did.
Yeah. Why did you leave this on my fucking apartment? Edited by Lynn Copeland. Good talk to her.
That bitch.
Did they hang up on you?
I'm still ringing.
Oh.
Maybe they have my number now. I should have *67.
Did you not? Don't leave a voicemail then. Because if we leave something foul, then.
Well, all right.
Yeah, we don't have to do it. We're going to get really aggressive. I fucking hate this shit.
Yeah, I do too. I was going to cuss them out. That's shitty. But I was going to tell them, you know, they suck.
Yeah. Be like, hey, you can't just drop this off on people and just fucking expect people to like.
I would ask them what they thought about Will Smith.
Yeah, honestly.
I would ask them to pray over my cousin D's nuts.
Yeah.
This is shitty. Don't do this because nobody cares. No one's getting converted by this. Oh my God.
I hate this shit. So, I had a story last week about these very obese people in Shaw's, how they were trying to like force veganism on people. They were like calling people
around. Can we burn this?
Yeah, of course. They were calling people around them idiots. Basically.
All right. So tell me more. I'm sorry. Rewind ignorant, a little bit. So you went to the grocery store.
Yeah. I don't want to get the whole story in because it was on the solo pod, but,
did it happen to you?
Yes. Basically I went to Shaw's a couple weeks ago and, okay. I was just walking around doing regular shopping, normal shit.
Sure.
And this very obese woman and her very obese son were openly talking about, well, I think it was her son. He was as chunky as her. Sorry to say
but
it.
Very but, young.
Yeah. Very young. Right. You know, not old enough to know what she was doing to him type of thing. I want to say like six, you know, like walking.
Oh, fuck.
Like walking, but tubby.
Oh, like Baylor.
Yeah. Like it was sad. And the mother was openly shitting on people for not being vegans. It's like, you're not
healthy.
Yeah. Whatever you're doing, it ain't working. Like, I hate being mean, but like she literally, so the one around the store, you could just hear mumbling shit. But then when I was in line, I could hear her getting in the back of line. It was pretty busy that day. And she was just like, yeah. And the son was like, why can't we get this? Like, I want something. I want this food. And she's like, no, not getting meats. You know, it's ignorance to eat like that. It's very ignorant to do anything other than vegetarians and like vegan stuff only. And openly shitting on people when she looked horrible, you know? So we're looking around. Like, I'm looking at the guy behind me like, you hear this whale over here? Fucking, and I was so mad. Yeah, and some guy in the line started yelling at her. I was like, oh, shit. Shut the fuck up. Yeah, because she was openly fucking talking shit.
He's like, mind your own fucking business.
Right. He basically was like, can you like just keep it to yourself if you're going to say shit like that? Like, he was like trying to be polite about it, but like, listen, lady, like, no one cares. Like, we're all trying to get out of here. Like, keep it to yourself.
No one fucking cares.
And she started screaming, dude.
Oh, did she?
Yeah, she was looking. Mind your fucking business. She was looking for a rise.
She was trying to get someone.
And I think she was trying to look for like free food or free groceries.
Did it escalate?
I don't know. I tuned the fuck out. As soon as I heard yelling, I just was thinking of like, oh yeah, that waitress down there.
I tune in, bro.
Yeah. Well, when it comes to shit like that,
I tune in hard.
When it comes to chaos,
I love it.
I find something and just focus on it. I don't know why. So when it's that type of shit, yeah, if I'm intrigued, I'll look at it. But no, dude, I've heard that argument too many times that I'm like, I don't care about this. Like, oh, this cash register looks cool. Oh, those buttons haven't been cleaned in a while. Like, that's where I just started going. Mm. Like, yeah. But that's what this reminded me of. Don't push this shit on people.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's pretty, yeah, yeah, exactly.
It's fucking bad. But have you ever been pushed? Like, I know as a child, huge, you know, we've talked about.
Bro, my mom suffocated the church.
Right.
Like, my mom suffocated me with the church. Like,
yeah.
It was to the point, I actually got in a really big argument with my mom, and it was really bad for like 6 months.
Yeah.
When I was around 16, I was like, Mom, I don't want to go to church anymore.
Right.
And she's like, why? I'm like, I don't believe in God. For me, there is no God.
Yeah.
And she's like, got really upset and cried and made a big scene and guilted me into going to church still. And I only went to church at that point because it was a social gathering. I just met other kids my age. And I actually like talked to girls and we went out.
Yeah.
And girls I'm still friends with today. A lot of girls. Church girls are a different breed, bro. Love it.
Yeah.
But I couldn't do it anymore. So yeah. I stopped going. What else?
I was going to say, has like a third party type of thing? Like when, as an adult, has someone like pushed something on you differently?
You know, I'm gonna give you an example of when someone pushed something on me and I bought it. So a couple years ago, this is when I first started working sales. I was working car sales maybe 3-4 years ago. I went to the mall, and in the middle of the mall there's this kiosk where they were selling this this heating packet. So it's a reusable heating pack that it's like a liquid, and you snap it and it turns into a solid, and solid is really warm, and you just whatever.
Yeah, I used to have one of those.
They're kind of cool.
Yeah.
Whatever. They come in a million different shapes.
Helped with like neck pain and shit.
I'm walking by, and it's like this man, maybe late 30s, early 40s. He's training a young woman. She's like in her late teens, early 20s. And he's training her to run the stand on her own. And he's like, you got to sell. And I can kind of like hear him like from over the corner. And when we pass the kiosk, he's like, watch this. He goes, hey, you young man, hey, come look at this. Hey. They call me over, like really, really bothering the fuck out. And I was with my buddy. And I was like, nah, man, I'm all set. I don't want it. I'm good. I don't care. But he just kept on going. And I respected the fact that he was so aggressive about it, because I was in car sales and I was being aggressive about sales myself. Car sales is a different breed from what I do today.
Yeah, right.
I was shoving cars down people's fucking throats.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So when this guy was shoving his shit down my throat, I like kind of respected it. I was like, I was walking, bro, I was 20, 30 feet away, and he's yelling, come here, come back. Just try it on. You don't have to buy. And I was like, I looked at my buddy, and I'm like, I kind of respect it.
Yeah,
like,
game recognized game, you know?
Game recognized game. Yeah. And he was like, bro, if you respect it, let's go check it out.
Yeah.
I was like, I don't want to buy anything, though. He's like, let's go check it out, whatever. And I was like, fuck it. So I was kind of enabled. So we went down.
Yeah.
I let him put all the heating packs on me, snap like the neck one, the arm one, the back one. I had like, I was covered in these heating packs. I'm like, this shit is fire, son. And I didn't ask how you recharge the fucking things, which is, I should have. Because that's the big kicker.
Okay.
But anyways, because after you put them into a solid, you need to bring them back to liquid. But I'll talk about that in a moment.
Right.
So he starts selling me and he's like, I'll give you this. I'll throw on this. And you're going to get 45 pieces. I'm like, all right, how much? $50. I'm like, $50 fucking? It's not a lot.
Yeah, but for that item, it sounds for the item,
a
little.
Like, I don't even want to buy this.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to spend $50 on it. I bought it.
Yeah.
So I was just like game recognized game.
Yeah.
And I was like, honestly, bro, like I'm going to let you know right now, I'm winning sales and you got me. I don't know why, but you did.
Yeah. You're like, this was well done. Can I guess at what the downfall is?
Yeah.
So for one, you didn't know how to get it back to the other form. So you need to buy an additional piece, I imagine.
Nope. Not even.
Okay.
I would prefer that. You got to boil them.
Oh, that sucks.
You got to boil them in water for 20, 30 minutes.
Oh, I remember that. Damn.
It's not a quick boil.
It's not a quick boil.
You got to put it in there, and then you got to make sure that they don't melt the packet itself.
Right.
So it's not overly boiling. You got to make sure they're not at the bottom. And then if you bought a big neck piece, like I did, like a big three-piece neck
that's
3 feet long.
Yeah.
How the fuck do you boil that except for in pieces, and it takes an hour and a half?
Yeah.
So you got these hot packs that only last 10, 15 minutes.
Right. That are essentially one-time use if you don't want to.
One-time fucking. So I used all of them. I handed them out to my family. And they're like, how do you recharge? I'm like, I don't know. It even said on the box. I had to look it up. I'm like, you have to boil it. I wouldn't have bought it, bro.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about it. If I had thought about how do you charge this, I wouldn't have bought it because it's such a hassle.
Yeah.
If you want to be warm, boil water and put that in a bag and put that on your neck. Don't fucking boil this shit for 30, 40 minutes.
Right. That is shitty. Yeah.
Super shit.
I guess, though, when it comes, like, because it's a sales type thing, I can almost respect that, too, to be honest, because it's just like, all right, you got me type of thing, you know?
Yeah, like you push so hard and you put yourself out there so much.
Yeah.
And, like, I kind of respect it.
Right. Yeah.
Game recognized game.
Yeah. No, that wasn't bad.
So
I feel like we went off on those fucking religious things.
I don't know. Krill Smith, Jada Lame It, Slame Smith. Cicada Pinkett Smith.
Cicada Pinkett?
That's her middle name. That was her last name before she married
Pinkett. Oh, you're right. Yeah, sorry.
Jada Pinkett.
The way I thought you were trying to rhyme it with something else, and I was like, what's a Pinkett?
Let's call her Cicada.
Cicada?
Cicada Pinkett Smith. Or Cicada Smith.
Nice. I'm with it. Cicada. Really? Yeah, why not?
Because it has an Ada at the end.
I mean, calling her a basketball hoop is a bit much anyways. It's just like an inanimate object.
She's just a dirty fly that no one fucking likes and makes a lot of fucking noise.
Yeah.
And hides in the ground for 12 years and then comes out.
Yeah. Speaking of catching up with the time. No one was actually catching up with the time.
Yeah.
I was trying to do the segue into like going back in order from where we were 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, where we left off. There we go. That's a better segue.
Oh, dude, that was wild.
I was trying to.
That's about like an hour ago. Yeah, what about it?
Bruce Willis has aphasia. Aphasia.
I don't know what that is. Has a what?
You didn't hear about this? Bruce Willis came out. He's retired. He's not acting anymore.
Mm-hmm.
He has aphasia or aphasia. Aphasia.
I don't know what that is.
It's dementia, but for words, basically.
Oh, yeah, so, yeah. So he can't speak very well.
Right. He will think of words to say, but as your brain tells your mouth, it just comes out jumbled. Sometimes words don't even come out at all. So I had some fucked up jokes at first. Like last week, I was like, yeah, I mean, how is that much different from his acting to begin with now? Like, he really doesn't have these complex monologues. Yeah. Like,
he's
you know,
this time, there won't be a next time.
Right, exactly.
Like, that's it. And you're like, okay.
You're about to die hard, you know? He didn't say that.
You're about to die hard.
Yeah.
Die.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Not on my watch. Like those corny ass like, fucking, you know, corny shit.
Over my dead body.
Right.
Scumbag.
Yeah. fucking jamokes. Like, he just has some stupid shit that's...
Hasta la vista. No,
that's it, Arnold. That's another song. same archetype.
Same shit, though. Same archetype. 100%.
So, yeah, 100%. I was saying that, but then I was like, oh, well, I mean, that would be kind of horrible, like, on his own personal life, obviously. But without getting serious into it, I watched, you know, because some of his late recent movies, like, I don't know, Bruce Willis is kind of a badass actor to me because he just has these dumb roles that, again, he didn't say much and he kind of just killed the role, you know? Yeah. Like, he didn't have to do much in it. Yeah. And it was like, yeah, he's an action guy, you know? Like, he's...
But, like, one of the best action guys.
Right, one of the good ones. Like,
because his visual is so intense.
Right.
You just got to look at him and see him do shit.
Yeah.
You know?
And he gets into it, you know?
I can see him in my head with a gun pointing at me. Like, that's what I can see.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I think, like, with him and even, like, Harrison Ford... Old ass Indiana Jones motherfucker. Yeah, yeah, like, I feel like they're like kind of, they kind of have a good badass archetype, you know? So I don't know. I've been watching his movies and he has some really shitty movies in the past few years.
Really?
Really bad. I always watch random shit on Amazon Prime, Hulu, shit that never hit theaters almost, just like underground type movies, low budget movies. Obviously, he's been in some shit ones, but he's just, you know, he's a billionaire or some shit by now anyways. He doesn't
fucking care anymore.
Exactly. He's just making money. But I watched a movie called American Siege that came out last year, 2021. Mm-hmm. Bro, you can tell he has aphasia in that movie.
Really?
Yeah. Like, it was sad. Like,
is it bad?
So, like, normally you hear him, and again, he has those things. He has those, like, you know... Not on my watch, or, you know, get the gun. I don't know. Just stupid shit one-liners almost all the time. Dude, in this movie, it's so bad. He goes, oh, watch out for the gunshot. It's like that slow.
Oh,
I'm like, oh. Shit. I'm like, yeah, he's like 80 now. Like, I don't like it. Like, it was kind of, I know, but that's what it felt like.
What are like? 60 maybe?
He has to be almost 70, yeah. It's like 68, 66, something like that. Which I feel bad, you know, but...
happens to all of us, bro.
Yeah,
I kind of died at some point.
Right.
Even a Bruce Willis and that motherfucker.
I mean, he probably lived a pretty party-going lifestyle. I mean, he's a pretty popular celebrity, you know?
Let me tell you something, bro. And this is one of my favorite things about Lion Age.
Yeah.
Because I bring up this really good point. I think it's accurate. These actors, these guys, their balls are always empty.
Yeah.
Always. Like, you and I, we live in a state of balls filling up, staying full for a couple hours, and then you empty them. Bruce Willis is always empty.
Always.
He has a woman in his trailer like, Mr. Willis, would you like me to suck your fucking cock? Like,
oh, it's not even a question at that point. She just starts doing it.
Yeah, she's on her knees, and she has knee pad.
Yeah, as soon as he walks in.
And he shoves it in, and nuts, and then goes to take a shit.
Yeah.
And when he's done taking a shit, he's like, I got a little left in the tank. I got to empty it. And she's like,
when he comes out of the bathroom, it's a new girl that's also waiting for him. They rotate. It's a schedule, you know?
He never has the same girl twice.
Never has the same girl.
It's a different girl every single time.
Yeah.
He's always empty, bro. He's always fucking empty. That's the secret.
It is, yeah.
And let me tell you, if it wasn't for that, he'd have a lot more than aphasia.
Yeah.
We're talking Alzheimer's.
He might have a lot more they're just putting out to the public that it's aphasia, you know? But honestly, I feel like people, like, you guys got to watch American Siege. Just to, like, you don't have to watch the movie.
Is it comical? Can I laugh?
That's actually why I only watched 40 minutes of it. It's such a bad movie. I couldn't get through half of it. But honestly, one of those movies where, like, he only has one-liners. He can't get through anything else. Yeah. And they're very slow and choppy. It's like, oh, like, damn. Yeah, it hit you hard.
They should make a movie where he doesn't speak.
Dude, that's what I was saying.
Mute.
Yeah.
He could be a mute fucking, like, action hero.
Yeah. Dude, so last fucking, when I was on that episode, I was like,
sign language.
Why doesn't he just do a silent movie and still be a badass role? He can still do.
John Krasinski fucking did it. And
yeah.
That movie was amazing.
That was a really good movie.
What movie?
Yeah. A Quiet Place. So
I was
going to
say
good.
Get Out, but I'm like, no, that's definitely not it.
Yeah. Also a very good movie. Great movie.
That movie was really fun. You see number two?
Get Out?
Yeah.
No. A Quiet Place. Very good.
I've not seen it.
I think the first one was better. It's more original, I think. The second one, continuation. The second one's intense. The second one's a little like, whoa.
He's not in it.
Right. Well, he's technically in parts of it. I don't want to spoil it for you, but yeah.
Like, flashbacks though, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I don't remember.
He's still dead in the
end. Yeah, no, he died.
He died in the first one, yeah.
Yeah, but they show like different scenes, of, like shots of the first one with different angles. It's like badass with him still in it. So I was like, oh, that's very smart how they did that.
He's the producer, or the director, rather.
Yeah, he directed
it. Do you remember his death scene? It's such a good scene.
Like, no.
They're getting chased or something, and they're like,
oh, fuck, yeah.
And then he goes outside, and he goes, I love you.
Right. Yeah.
I love you. Like he says, like, that's his dying thing.
Yeah, because he knows he's going to die. Yeah. He has to sacrifice himself. Yeah. So that's what he gets out. And they're like crying, but trying not to.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
That was, again, that must have been a crazy movie to shoot, like, with your wife, too. And
I'm sure that his real wife?
Yeah, Emily Blunt's his real wife.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And he directed it. And I don't think those were
they got
kids,
an actual deaf actor or
the girl
actor.
Yeah, she doesn't speak. Actually does it, so
I think she's mute deaf or just mute, I don't know.
Yeah, but I wanted to bounce back for a second in regards to Will Smith. Jesus, why do I keep saying Will Smith for Bruce Willis? Why
that's the second time.
It's Bruce Willis, so yeah, I keep thinking
that's what
yeah
it is. it's the will
In bad movies in general. So we talked about this once when I came on here, God, months ago. I like bad movie takes better than good movie takes.
Okay.
You know, because I saw this movie. It was phenomenal. Yeah. I think a lot of movies are great. You know,
sure.
I'm pleased easily by good movies or just movies in general.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Bad movies are rough for me because it has to be really bad for me not to like it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Bro, I watched Fast and Furious 9. That's the worst movie I've ever seen.
Seriously?
Number one spot.
That's the latest one, right? That's the newest one?
I don't think it's the newest. I think there's 11, I think.
Was that the one where he dies?
Dom, I think, right? Or one of them?
No, the actor. The actor actually died. What's his name?
Oh, no. Paul Walker. He's not in Fast and Furious 9. So he did die, I think, in Fast 8. Or before Fast 8.
Or Fast 7 or something like that.
Right. But I think...
I believe they made so many.
There's another after 9, too. That's not the last one. There's a 10 or 11, I'm pretty positive.
Oh, my God.
Because there's one where Dom dies.
The most recent one I've seen was Tokyo Drift. That one was awesome.
Phenomenal. God.
Phenomenal.
I think even the 4th and 5th were okay. That's just when they started getting, like, to a war unit and stuff.
Well, yeah. It stopped being about, like... It became Ocean's 11 at one point.
It was like, wild. Like,
with
cars, where did this come
and
from?
Guns and helicopters. I'm like, huh?
Yeah. Like, oh, we're now working with SWAT because you guys are very skilled drivers and now you just happen to be skilled gun users. Like, okay.
Did you finish it?
In Fast 9, bro, just guess at what they try to do in that movie. Because they always try to push the limit in every fucking movie, right? They always try to do some crazy shit with cars try to guess what they do.
So they go... they're on a car and they go skyscraper to skyscraper, down, and at the very bottom level there's a helicopter. So they jump into the helicopter and try to park it in the middle, and then the helicopter makes a quick escape and they fly away.
No,
that's what I imagine.
It's worse.
it's worse than that. That's like the worst car scene.
So
I can imagine.
There's one part,
okay,
right?
That's pretty
there's
shitty.
One. I'll give you three parts that are horrible.
Okay.
The three worst parts of this movie, but I watched the whole movie because of how fucking fun it was, because of how bad it was.
Yeah.
Like,
you just got high and watched the whole thing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I was actually a little drunk through half of it. I was like, I'm going to start drinking. This is hilarious.
Bro, this shit is making me drink, bro. That's a fucked up movie.
Yeah.
All right.
One scene, Dom jumps off of a cliff with his vehicle, right? So he goes off of a cliff and he's not aiming for anything. He just goes flying off the cliff, and there's a bridge in a different part of the cliff that snaps, and the hook from the bridge caught his car in midair.
Shut the fuck up.
Swung him across the valley, through the cliff,
and
to the other side.
And broke at the perfect part and landed him
on the other side.
Perfect.
First dumbest thing that I've ever seen in that movie. The second dumbest
that's
thing.
That's an amazing scene. I want to see
that. The second dumbest thing I've ever seen.
That sounds outrageous.
They go to space.
In the cars?
In the car.
Wait, the cars go to space?
One of the cars, they put
a rocket
on it.
Shut
and it,
the
sh- it go-
fuck
I swear.
No,
and
don't.
Guess who goes, right? It's Ludacris and Terry.
The main guy.
No.
No?
The black dude that's from the first two movies.
I don't know. I don't remember. They go to fucking. They put a rocket.
Roman
on the
Pierce. Head. I remember him saying. He's like, yo, Pierce. Roman Pierce. I remember Paul Walker saying that in the second movie.
All right.
He's the black dude.
All right.
So the two black dudes end up going to space.
They die up there.
No, they survive.
They make it back?
They make it back,
on
too.
On the car?
Yeah.
Hold on.
In the car.
So do they go to the space station or they just fly into space?
They put a rocket on it and I think they just drive, and then eventually the rocket turns on and they just go like that.
And then there's a scene where he
pumps up
the gas, right? He's in air and it goes, it floors it.
Yeah.
And it goes faster.
Yep.
That's fucking ass, bro.
And in space, they're just floating around kind of by the earth, you know, because the car made it through the atmosphere perfectly fine. It didn't break or crack or anything.
Yeah,
you know,
the windshield.
A regular car. Just, yeah, right. You know, like the space air didn't go through the vents or anything, but no, it's fine. While they're in space, because they have space helmets on in their cars, they somehow manage to go back to Earth, but they don't show it. They just are back home at one point.
So it doesn't show them like
back in
the ocean, right, and land in the ocean.
Right. They don't show it at all.
They don't make that.
Yeah. I literally was like, there's
the same movie?
It's in Fast 9. Yeah. I was like, there's no way this movie is this fucking outrageous. There's a third piece of this. There's a third one that I want to say isn't as dumb. That the space thing might be the dumbest.
The space is really fun. The bridge was ludicrous, but the space thing is fucking ridiculous.
Yeah. The third one was their cars are pretty much boats at this point. They're submarines too.
No, they're not submarines, bro.
Yeah, there's a point where there's a submarine that's like attacking them in vehicles, and they make one of the vehicles like go underwater. Or
is it like a transformer? Or is it like a submarine?
Yeah, it's just, I don't know. They somehow modify it to go underwater. It's, dude, the dumbest, worst movie.
I'm gonna
movie.
Have to watch it.
It's really so fun to watch because
I'm
of how dumb.
I'm gonna have to watch it tonight.
Yeah.
Is it a long movie?
Yeah, it's like 2 hours, you know.
Really? I don't think I could sit through that in one sitting, bro. I'd have to split it up in two.
Break it up in a few, dude. Might be four or five.
Five.
Yeah, dude.
Like, bro, you get to one, you're like, I'm done.
Yeah.
I'm moving on. Yeah, it's pretty fucking.
So, yeah, the American Siege movie with Bruce Willis that I couldn't get through half of it, this movie was worse than that, but it was so drastically
so much worse
dumb
better.
That you had to keep watching. It was that, like, yeah. Okay. And honestly, I would have believed them jumping and landing a vehicle in a helicopter before the shit that they did in this movie.
Yeah, I thought like what I was going to say, and that's the most tame thing of what you've told me.
Yeah.
Yeah, jumping off a building into a helicopter, parking in the helicopter, and the helicopter making an escape is tame compared to what the fuck you just
from what
me.
I just, yeah, exactly. And again, in Fast 8, they did some crazy shit like that. In Fast 10, they do even worse shit. So it's like you guys are just making fun of your audience.
You said
this
in 9?
Yeah, this is Fast 9. It's on HBO Max and shit right now. So.
I always pirate these movies. I don't pay. Fuck these fucking...
Yeah.
Who gives a shit?
Yeah, so I wanted to...
Movie joy.
I want to... I mean, we have so many videos and shit we can get to, but...
Yeah, can we hit a couple?
God, we're past an hour already.
Oh, yeah, let's do a couple videos.
Well, I want to talk about one specifically that isn't necessarily... well, we could do this first because this is interesting.
Oh, I already like the caption. It just sock up Jellivin.
No, this is one I sent myself actually. Why is this bringing me to this part and not the fucking? So basically, someone got tossed around by a tornado in a Walmart parking lot.
You could see it,
and you could see it. There was footage of it.
I want to see. Pressing the account. Maybe you. This is March 21st, so it wasn't that long ago.
Yeah.
You want to hit this?
Sure.
Oh. Oh, I thought that was her flying up in the sky and shit.
Look at the fucking people. Run! They're grabbing onto the poles and shit.
A car? You don't see a car in there.
That does look like a person up there.
It does look like a foot. Maybe it's like a jacket. I didn't think tornadoes are that dangerous. I thought it was the debris that was dangerous.
Well, no, this is like right under one, I think. This is like a pretty direct tornado.
Can we go back to the photo of her knee?
Yeah, so this one you can't really see it that well.
Oh,
but
is there better? Yeah. So then keep on finding better photos. My bad.
Yeah, so this like, so people were like, so like they're running on the parking lot, right? And then they like feel like a wicked hard tug, like a wind is pulling them somewhere.
Yeah, it's like
so
a wall
drop,
of wind.
You know?
Yeah, exactly.
I was like, oh shit, that's badass.
We've all been in situations where it's a wall of wind, bro, and that shit knocks you down.
Yeah.
Way stronger than intended to.
Okay, so I don't know how
this
easy this is gonna find.
No, you're not gonna find shit.
All right. Well, yeah, I just thought that was cool. I was like, oh fuck. Like I've never seen like a video of people like actually having injuries from a tornado,
yeah,
you know?
That's crazy.
Like it's normally
that's crazy.
This thing. That's fucking wild. I don't want to get into this yet because this is a whole deep dive conversation, but I think that's for like a music episode.
Yeah, by streams. Yeah, yeah. You didn't know. Bro, J. Cole put this out on his album.
He did.
Years ago, bro. I think it was on Four Wheel Drives.
And a lot of people didn't believe him. And a lot of this video that keeps popping up, they keep getting taken down by major labels. Yes. They're like saying like it's like illegal for some false misadvertisement or something like that. Yeah. But this is like now like Vice articles are doing shit on it. You can't take Vice down.
No.
So they found him and they're real. They're like, yeah, he's like, there's someone that's charting currently as of March 20th. He's
and they like, they all have like 50 phones apiece.
Right. And every single person there's working. What we're looking at, people, sorry, we're not describing it further. It's a label farm for streaming, basically.
So there's a room full of people and every person has a million phones in front of them and they're all watching YouTube videos just to get streams
out. Yeah, you got to see. I'll show the video.
I thought a bot would do it. This is very inefficient to have people to do it.
So this is organic. This can't be flagged as bots. So like you can't get taken down for buying this because it's real people. It's real phones. So it's like they found a fucking loophole. But they're feeding money into major labels who are, again, probably the ones who told them to... They're probably the ones who had them build this in the first place.
Having an operation like this pays for itself.
Right.
And then some, because these people, the wages of all these people, but they're running. Imagine if your job is you got to sit here for 8 hours and play YouTube videos on these 50 phones.
Yeah.
You have an efficiency rating where you can only have 1 second of downtime between every video. You have to always be watching videos.
Right.
Bro, it pays for itself.
Yeah.
With the ad revenue and with the, and then you get the exposure. Oh, this has a million views.
Right.
Cool. This is popular.
Yeah.
Wow.
And the YouTube monetization too. Like a certain amount of views on YouTube, you can just start getting paid just for having your video up. You don't even need to advertise anything.
The way you could block this is by setting IP addresses and like recognizing and doing only one IP uniquely per time. But then the issue with that is, what if you have a home that has a family and five kids and they all watch different YouTube videos?
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I mean, that's another whole deep conversation.
Yeah, that's a whole... Right, that's and you just said... I don't want to go deep, so let's move on.
And I'll wrap up with this too. That can't, like, I don't know how to put it. Artists that will have millions of streams but can sell 5 show tickets, that's why.
Yeah.
But artists like Tyler, the Creator, who sell out 20,000 seats at a stadium.
And stadium,
and
bro.
Stay there, you know? Like, those, they probably even, I mean, the label might still buy streams, but it's not
I'm
needed,
sure everybody you know? Does it because, like I said, it pays for itself.
Right,
if
right.
you're not doing this, it's a, I've seen this. This shit is fucking
We got to talk about it. Bro. You think it's funny?
It's embarrassing. It's funny because DaBaby
tried to kiss his fan, and she curved him out a mayo.
Look at him. He looks drunk. He's barely standing.
He looks real lit.
He looks drunk.
So, like, I've seen some very interesting...
Did she smack him?
Very interesting takes on this.
Yeah.
Which I wanted to do a deep dive on.
So, what we're watching is we're watching a video of DaBaby. He is in front. He's, like, getting out of a car. He's, like, getting to a venue or leaving from... Look, dude, he's staggering. He has someone holding him up, dude.
Yeah.
He's dead, bro. He's so fucking wasted.
He's really fucking wasted. His security and his PR staff is not doing their job.
Like, they're holding him up to keep him standing up. And he's in front of a group of fans that are all trying to take pictures and shit. And he goes up to this one pretty girl and puts his hands on both sides of her face and goes up to kiss her. And she moves away from him twice, and then he backs up and stops. So he doesn't forcibly kiss her. He is aggressive about this.
Yeah.
And she says no, right? She says no, but he does stop.
Right.
So this isn't as cringe as people say it is.
Exactly. Yeah. And I'm honestly, exactly what you just said is, oh fuck, no volume. Exactly what you just said is exactly how I feel about it.
Yeah.
To a T.
Yeah.
Don't think there was a deep malicious intent behind
100%.
It.
100%.
I'm not about all that, but 100%. So this female, this black female tweeted this and it blew the fuck up. Mm-hmm. And she was like, I don't give a fuck what anyone says. This has rape intent behind it. And she could see it in his eyes.
Maybe. Exactly. I don't know enough.
We're going to joke on it after. That's all we're going to do. But her thought was like, this happens with like major artists like this. They don't just like, people are like, oh, they don't need to like just go out fishing for girls. Like, they can get whoever they want.
And, right.
You know, girls aren't going to be victims of this type of stuff when they're this big. And then she was like, no, they're very much still the victims. This is rapey as fuck, canceling DaBaby, et cetera, et cetera. We're like, I get that one point of it. We're like,
correct.
You know,
I do get it. I do get it.
I get that point.
I do get it.
But again,
I do get it.
He was blackout drunk here.
Clearly.
He does not remember this.
Yes.
He does not know this even happened.
Which is not an excuse.
Not an excuse at all. Not an excuse.
But it is a reason.
Yes.
And it does explain this. And again, I totally agree with you. I think you're absolutely right.
Right.
And this, just let's put it in perspective. This is, he's young. Mm. He's mega rich.
Yeah.
Out of nowhere too. Like within the last 4 or 5 years.
Yeah.
And he's handsome. He has kids, bro. He's one of the most famous people in America right now.
Yeah.
I mean, bro, imagine the fucking skyride this guy's living on every single day.
Right.
And then you're drunk. It's the middle of the night. You're in a group of 100 adoring fans. Like, he's a rock star.
Yeah.
We've seen rock stars do worse than this.
Right.
Elvis Presley married a 14-year-old, didn't he?
Yes, yeah.
What's more?
Yo, Chris Brown beat the shit out of Rihanna. Like, what the fuck are we talking about?
He's still making music.
Of course. Right? Like, get the fuck out of here.
Canceling, here's the thing about canceling. I think you can make an individual decision to say, I don't like this person, I'm no longer going to support. But I think that has to be an individual decision. It has nothing, there's no mass movement. I don't think that's right. But I'm watching this video, I analyze it. From what I can see here, it looks cringe. It's aggressive. It's unprovoked. It's, you know, maybe he should settle and give her a little bit of cash and be like, hey, I'm sorry I did that to you. Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe.
I will say what he is doing here isn't right. It's not.
Like, it's not right. I'm not
trying
saying it's right.
To kiss. I know you're not saying it. I'm just saying like, because I don't want people to take what we say as defending him.
100%. Because, you know? I don't give a fuck about the baby.
I don't either. I don't give a shit.
I don't give a shit.
I'm not a huge fan of his music either. I've heard some good songs, but I don't listen to him.
But it's whatever.
Whatever. I will say, like, God, like you said, dude, he's 25 or under. This 12-second clip has 12 million views.
Right.
That's a million per second. 12 seconds, 12 million views. That's fucking insane. Like, you're really fucking famous at that point, you know?
Right.
I don't know. He was obviously, he drank too much that day. He had fun. That's it for me. That's it.
You know?
I don't think, I don't know.
I think you nailed it.
If he's a piece of shit, he's a piece of shit. If not, he's not.
That's it.
And we're good. That's it. You know? I was like, we should do some type of conversation on that.
I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
Can we go to the videos I sent you?
Of course. Do I do IG? I don't know. I wanted to look because I can't remember with fucking Twitter.
I think I sent some good shit, though. Let's
I feel like all the shit Jake sends me on Twitter is usually pretty fucked up, so.
Jake is the man. Jake is... So, hold on. Before we press on one of this thing, so we're putting up shorts on our podcast.
Yeah.
And now it's getting more exposure and people are listening to it. We're obviously getting a lot of new listeners. Not to say we have a fan base, but we definitely have a vibe and we definitely have an energy that we hit. Jake, you made a short of something he said.
Yes. You want to talk about it?
Let's go into it a little bit. Because who cares?
Yeah.
Right?
Well, so, I did. I talked about it last week, but I went off, so I had to cut it.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. Okay. I got aggressive.
Yeah. So we put a stupid little story out where Jake said when he drives by homeless guys, he drives up on the puddles to splash them.
Yeah, like he purposely hits the puddles to splash the homeless people.
Well, right. And then he laughs at them. Right. And, like, throw shit, whatever.
Yeah.
And... I mean, that's just Jake, though.
Right.
He's not actually doing that. And, like, and maybe he did once.
Yeah. The way I said it, this is my defense last week. Jake doesn't wake up in the morning rubbing his hands together like, I can't wait to splash that homeless guy today. He's not doing that.
He's not doing
that. You know? He's just a sick fuck.
He's just a sick fuck.
We're kind of sick in the head. He's a little sicker.
I give him more than a little. You know, he's a little sicker in the head than the average folk.
But again, we're satire. This is a dark humor comedy podcast.
Right.
We're very passionate about shit, so we just get really intense.
It's just like stupid. Yeah,
you exactly. know?
None of but this. Yeah. we could be sitting here lying about everything we said.
Yeah.
None of this. None of these things could be true.
I say in the disclaimer for this, I actually had to put at the bottom of it. I did this like 40 episodes ago because I didn't want to get us fucking sued. Everything that we say on this is either exaggerated or alleged for comedic purposes.
100%.
You know, and that's it right there. We're done.
That's it.
Opening close.
But
shut up.
People commented on that. Not a lot. Like, it was like maybe two or three or four. Did you delete some? I noticed there was like a lot.
There were a lot more, dude. and they were so bad that I didn't delete them. YouTube deleted them.
For real?
Yeah. They, yeah. One of them, they called you a big gay brown gay ass faggot. Like it was like
really?
Super, super That's aggressive.
That's fucking awesome. Did yeah, they really say that?
I was
that?
Like all like punching.
Is there
punching.
Somewhere I can see it?
It doesn't like, it was only in the first like, basically,
that's fucking sweet.
Basically,
dude.
Those comments for like 48 hours are up there. And if you can see them, great. And if they drop words like that, YouTube gets them within, like they're fast, you know? So, but yeah, they
you
went off
me a
on.
Big brown gay ass. That's yeah. fucking
With
awesome,
me,
dude.
That they kept, they were just kept saying, like, whoever the fuck this guy is mad annoying. Some people were calling me Canadian. So they were saying Canadian faggot a bunch of times.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This other guy called me a Nazi. So it went on the other side of the spectrum there.
Yeah,
I was
sure,
like, okay,
sure,
right,
sure.
Right,
yeah.
It goes
right,
up,
yeah,
right.
I get it.
But yeah, so again, the YouTube shorts, I kind of feel them to a degree because it just, it's like TikTok
it's
where
it's
shotgunning
it to a million people.
Randomly shoots it off.
I think our shorts shouldn't be that heavy. We should probably keep our shirts a little lighter.
I tried to make the tags very specific too, where it's like dark humor, satire, yeah, but yeah. apparently that didn't fucking matter. So I was like, all right, we'll just do.
I think the context is also, not to say there was a lot of context.
Well, there wasn't any really for that one.
But like when you're watching, you get the energy. And by the time you get to that point, you're like, okay, I know these guys are just being fucking idiots.
Did you see the most recent short? We should watch it real quick.
Can we?
Just because, yeah.
Is it new? I haven't, if you put it up new, then no. I like I said, I only saw when you had two or three shorts up there, that's what I saw.
Yeah, no, it is new.
Yoi.
And I think I can show this because it's my own fucking
it's
content,
your
right?
Video, yeah.
Like,
I know we can react to videos. You can sit here and watch a video and have our reaction there.
Oh,
we
it's the music. That's what it is. The second the music is copyrighted, you can't fucking play it. Or you can mute that whole section.
Right.
But
it's a couple, they give you a couple seconds as a buffer. Like if you make a mistake.
Exactly.
Or,
yeah.
It's not mute.
It's like at least 5 seconds. But yeah, cool. The For the Boys. Did you see that one?
No, I didn't.
So this, again, already at 465 views. Like these grow traction because they're in the shorts format.
Do we have death threats on this one?
No. You can tell from like, just from the context of what it is. There's no reason for it, you know?
I didn't go and piss once by accident.
Yo.
Hot. I'm like, this is hot. And then I was like, this tastes bad. And I'm like, this is piss.
Yeah.
I spit it back into the cup and I continued playing my game because I drank my own piss once by accident.
See? So it's not.
I'm like, this is.
And that
hot.
Text isn't there. That's just because it's the computer.
Yeah. I know how you can. I watch a lot of shorts. Imagine if I come up on our own shorts, just like scrolling. That'd be sick.
Right? That's what I'm hoping for too.
I'm in the same. Yeah. When did you put this up?
But I don't know. 2 or 3 days ago.
It got less views than the other one, though. It's less. Maybe because we're getting interaction with that other video is getting shot to more people.
And that's also like, the polarizing stuff gets more views, dude. The stuff that's fucked up gets more views. If last week I call Amber Heard a dumb bitch looking at the camera mad times, and then immediately after I'm like, you're not a bitch. I'm sorry. This is really aggressive and I'm just intense right now. I'm in the moment. But I wanted to put that as a short because of how hard I'm like hammering.
Yeah, yeah.
And again, like you see like,
huh. We gotta play this fucking game,
perfect example. Ari Shaffir making fun of Kobe Bryant right when he passed. Blew the fuck
up. Yeah, dude. That was everywhere.
And he does. He has, 80,000 followers?
It was super tasteless. So,
but that's what I mean. That what Jake tasteless. Said was not that tasteful either.
Yeah,
he's just splashing homeless people.
Yeah,
so
I agree.
I think the polarizing shit is good to put out there. Yeah. But again, when they listen to us, hopefully they'll be like, all right, these kids are actually pretty funny.
Well, maybe if we do that, we hit more people and more people are like,
yeah.
They're on the train.
Right.
All right. I guess we'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
I like that you dug deep to that up there.
Yeah,
episode.
No, I'm definitely I'm digging into all the YouTube shit, the YouTube shorts and shit. How far back are we? Hold on. We did look at this one already, I think.
No, we have. I don't think we have.
Yeah, not on the pod. I looked at this because this is what, April something, so.
Yeah. This is the Will Smith.
This is okay. Mine as well.
Video.
Shout out to Bad Friends.
Love Bad Friends. This is a great clip. And no music either. I think we could just play it, huh?
His hair the way that Carlos is. He's like the Mexican Larry David. He's like Luis David.
Look at the little pops out.
And Carlos is, what do you do? What do you
do? Smacks the shit out of him.
Keep Carlos's name out of your fucking mouth.
Yeah.
Dude, it was like a Mexican Larry David joke. Keep Carlos's name out of your fucking mouth. Okay.
I fucking love Fancy B, by the way.
Yeah, but Fancy's not losing his hair.
What a
Carlos
great
is.
Fucking he's like clip. This is the day after the Will Smith thing.
The day after, dude. This was fucking...
It was amazing.
That face, too, when he just goes away. Carlos
yeah, he just, like, walks out. Love it. I sent you a couple ones.
Bad Friends is so good.
The orange, I
want
to see the orange.
We do want to, we got to watch the orange one.
Yeah, the orange one's really good. This, I don't remember this one. Was this one good?
I do remember this. This was the, yeah, we might as well watch
might
it.
Might as well, fuck it. Yeah. Might as well. What do we got here? Oh, this is just nonsense, I think. Yeah. I love this shit.
I'm going to ask you one more time. Where's the clitoris?
I don't know.
Where's the clitoris?
Fuck.
Yeah. This one was pretty good.
Clean, you know?
Clean.
Dumb joke.
Dumb, good. Quick, clean, like quick. Executed really well. Right. So this girl's sitting down. She's drinking
Where's
water. And there's this guy tied up. She
Where's
goes up to him, smacks him. He's like, where's the clitoris? It's just like a stupid joke.
Right. They play on the movie scenes, you know, when they rip the tape off. Where the fuck's the bomb?
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly. And it's like, where's the clitoris? Yeah. He's like, fuck you. I'm not going to tell you.
It's only a myth. It's damn real.
Yeah. This is a great one.
I actually think, I'm just a sidebar, those jokes are mad funny to me. Damn it, scrolling fast. The jokes where girls like, because not to name drop, I'll just censor it, even though we've said their names so many times, but Haley said that to Jake one of the times I was with them recently, where she's just like, oh, not like you can find it. And I don't know why. Yeah. I laugh every time. Yeah, it's wicked fucking funny.
It is funny.
Like,
when girls say it's really funny.
I don't know why. Yeah. It's dumb.
Not that you can find it.
Watch. It's Gyneminosaurus, whatever you say, Gigantosaurus.
Gymetamorphosis.
Gigantonorstis. Gymornis.
Gymornis.
This orange is Gyneminosaurus.
Oh,
whatever
fucking
you say,
love it.
See, that almost sounds like St. Louis.
Gymetamorphosis.
Gymetamorphosis.
John
Like he's reassuring himself. He's
I don't know why that sounds like St. Louis to me. They're like, you know, her over her and over there.
No,
you know, look at your her. That's like St. Louis shit that for some reason sounds a little bit like that to me.
So you got this orange. You got this young guy. He's wearing like football attire, chilling with a do-rag on, eating a big ass orange, and he's trying to say that
fucking orange.
I don't even know what the fuck is. He's trying to say the orange is gigantic.
Yeah, or ginormous.
Ginormous.
He's doing both and
he's
combining them.
He's
doing gigantenormous.
Gigantenormous. Gigantenormous. Gigantenormous. Gigantenormous. And
a saurus.
Like. He's like ginormous. And it's so dumb.
Oh, I do remember that. DJs just be saying any wild shit before the
drop.
This
is a crackhead or a meth head that cracked.
Yeah,
me
dude,
up,
this
bro.
Was fucking wild when I saw
would
this.
Leave this guy alone, bro. You know, about look at this guy. He got moves, bro.
Nothing, dog. You don't know shit, homie. You don't know what love is.
You don't know what love is, bro?
This is meth. Yeah.
Look at him.
This is a shit.
I'm not even flexing,
shit
my guy.
Meth.
I can flex like a motherfucker, dog. Look, he's ripped, bro.
He is.
He's fucking ripped.
And he's got fucking, he's in the rhythm, you know? He found the inner peace.
Yeah, he found the inner peace. And dude, I get it if this guy is like harassing people in the street.
Oh, he's definitely harassing everyone there.
So?
Oh, bro, he's meth. This is meth. If there's cops and police around you and you're coked out, you're paranoid as fuck. You're sketching, you know? You're like, fuck, like shit, what did I do? Like, fuck, I'm not gonna like freak out. Meth, you interact with them. You get their attention. You want them to play with you, you know? Like, meth is like, I need you to help me with this type of thing.
Do you see how it ends, though?
Yes.
The way it ends is amazing. We just got to the ending. I think this is a full minute long, so I might have to wait another minute. I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna be real with you.
I don't think you can hear it in the ending. Can you in this one?
Yeah, you can. This is going to take a second. If I could try drugs with no repercussions once.
Yeah.
I'd experiment. I would. But that's not a world we live in.
Do you mean like no bodily?
Like, yeah.
Wrap it up, cops. That's what it was, right?
Yeah. No. It's coming. When he starts untying the dog, he's like, all right, we're done now. We're going to end it. He's like, damn, really? It's going to happen in a second here. And then I'll say what I want to say. It's coming. This guy's vibing, bro. He's moving.
What I want you to do is treat others how you were treated. Let's finish this. Are you going to let it go now?
You gonna let it go? He's gonna let. He's gonna stick the thumb in it.
Fuck, man.
Yeah, he's like, you gonna let it go now? Fuck, man. He's like upset.
Wait a second.
So this guy's methed out in front of a car dealership, it seems like. And these cops are standing there with canines just watching them geek out. But, like, it doesn't look like he has a weapon on him or a gun or a sword. He's just,
this geeking. This is what I'm getting from this, right? I'm going to read this situation. This fool is actually a normal dude, but he tried meth.
Oh, you think so, bro?
That's what I think. And you this is him on meth. Dude, if you're
this is what meth does.
If you're a recurring meth head, you are not going to be that fit. That's one thing, you know? Because they starve themselves for days and days and days. But
you think this guy is ripped? And I don't think he looks cut, but he looks cut naturally. Like, I think he would have been that weight.
I don't think it's like weights or anything or calisthenics, you know? Like,
I mean, maybe, bro. I don't know.
He's pretty thin. But
you can do meth and have a hobby, or if you do meth, is meth your whole identity?
I don't know, man. I think the second you're in, if you get hooked on it, you can't get out. You're in, you know?
But this guy is ripped, which is why I get your point. This guy could be.
It's just because he looks fit, but you could be right. It could just be all like.
He's jacked. He's cut.
Like, he's not that vascular, I guess. Maybe if veins were popping out, that'd be better.
Yeah, like, look at him. Like, he just looks really skinny. I don't know.
That's a clean body, though.
But where does he live? On the fucking Jersey Shore, bro, where they work out every day?
No body fat, so he just does meth and work out all day.
Exactly, right? Like, maybe this is the thing. Yeah. I believe you.
Damn.
This actually looks like a lot of fun.
It does. You know, he's like, out of all the bad shit that you could be doing, that's not that bad of like a, you know, the worst part, I imagine, is that he's probably just can't.
Bothering people.
Yeah. And he probably can't
get
stop.
The fuck out. Hold on. I actually do want you to play this video, but hold on. Okay. I want to finish this thought before we move on. Bro, if I could do drugs at the end of my life, they sit you down in a room, they go, all right, which ones you want to try, son? You got a month and a half, 2 months. You're going to try as many drugs as you want. And you're young, you're going to die. So let's go for it. I try them all.
Everyone. So when you say no repercussions, you mean for the law, of course.
Well, for the law and healthy. So like,
what I'm worried about.
If you go to the hospital, they're not going to OD you. They're going to weigh you. They're going to give you the exact amount. He's going to get you to the trip. And then
I still wouldn't do it. If I can try a drug and know that it will not affect me afterwards, my body will.
But you're going to die. I mean, like, I'm on my deathbed.
Ew.
I'm dying.
Well, then, yeah, I do every single drug in the possible world.
Because I'd like that looks insane.
Yeah.
And I would never put myself in that position.
Well, I mean, if I had terminal cancer, I'd do the same thing, to be honest.
Maybe this guy does. Maybe some of those people do.
Yeah. He's like, well, I got a month left.
They're like,
who has math?
Like, you got maximum 2 years. It's like, you're done, bro. Yeah.
See, that's
like,
I never
had kids. I never got married. And he's like, well, I'm going to do math and geek out for the next 2 years.
Yeah. I don't know.
You know, maybe I do the same. And who could blame him? Bro, human life is fleeting. I think we return to the void we come from. And I think that's a very sad thing. But we don't have to go down that.
I don't know. I'm a strong believer. I know we're going to get deep now, but I'm a strong believer that the world gives back to us what we put out to it. You know what I mean? So
it's chaos. I think the world is a massive equation, numerical, that when run infinitely, it just puts you in random situations. And I think you are what you are. And we're lucky, bro.
I think that's the truth.
We could have been born in fucking Africa. And then who are you going to curse?
Yeah.
Like, that's your existence.
Right.
We could have been born rich.
Right.
Could have been Jeff Bezos' son.
Yeah.
Does he have a son?
I hope not.
Maybe.
Probably, right?
Probably.
Yeah. He has a bunch of frozen fucking babies.
Like,
somewhere.
He got nuts in Chicago and New York and California and Texas. He got nuts everywhere, frozen, ready to unleash an army of little Zuckerbergs upon the world. It's a mix.
Yeah.
They took.
Just robotic
they
ass.
They took Jeff Bezos and Zucky Boy and they gestated.
Yes, I want to say you're on the right path.
They
adjudicated.
That sounds like
a little too far.
That sounds like a legal term.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But anyways, they.
I know what you're trying to.
They put the skeets together and they boiled it.
Right.
And then when they boiled, they melded, and then they actually implanted it in a seed and gave birth, and took that creature and took its skeet.
And that's how X-Men are born.
And that's the skeet that...
I think that's how mutated genes would come across. That's how it would happen. We got to boil skeets and burn skeets together. And
We were talking about the beauty of life when we're talking about boiling skeet.
So. That did take fault. A quick 180. That's that was that was strangely up then down.
that was strange.
Yeah.
So
what is this?
I'm gonna tell you, bro. Have you seen it? No? Great. So I seen this morning. I don't think you've seen it. So
I haven't then. Yeah.
Why am I active now? I'm not even on Instagram.
Wait, hold on. Let me watch it first. That would preface.
Okay.
Because I would have done that anyways, right?
So he just said, I'm begging you, and threw his swords down.
Right.
I'm in your debt. I'll read it out to you. I'm going to read it out. He goes, I'm in your debt. That's his captain. All right, my bad. I'm going to stop. No context. No context. If you want to take his place, most of all his pain and suffering, take his pain and suffering into yourself. It is impossible for you to survive. You are on the brink of death. You will die.
Is this music a part of?
No, this is just separate music. Emotional. So he's up. Okay.
No, all right, I'm gonna have to mute the clip then. But
this is a cover. This is a cover, so I don't think.
Well, I can still just mute that clip with our mics still going. So.
What's happening here? No. Nothing happened. And he maintains that. So what you just saw is the most badass clip in One Piece, which is my number one top anime. It has 1,000 episodes. It's been going on for almost 20 years. It's amazing. It's still going today. It is the most bought manga on the planet by a margin of like 50%.
Jesus Christ, really?
It has a massive monopoly.
How is it that high over Naruto?
It's the best.
Bruh.
It's the best. So in this clip, this is around episode 400, 500. They go to an island. They fight a warlord. They took so many. They're like, they're on their deathbed, bro. That's why the captain on the ground, he's like fought until like he's passed out. This is the captain's right-hand man, Zoro. He's the swordsman. He has no power. He's just a swordsman, bro. So this guy comes, and after they fight, this guy shows up to the island. He's another warlord. He goes, I'm going to kill you all. I'm going to take your head. He's the only conscious one there. And he goes, I'll do anything, please. He throws his sword because he knows he can't beat him.
Right.
So he throws his swords. He goes, I'm begging you. Take my head, please. So he goes, he has a power. So he picks up the captain and puts a paw to him because he has the paw power. And he solidifies his pain and suffering in a big ball. And he goes, this is all the damage that your captain has taken.
It will kill you.
So there's a scene where he takes a small piece and he takes massive damage. She goes, you cannot survive this.
So who's the one complaining at it afterwards then? Nothing.
That's happened. Another guy. That's okay. I'll tell you in a second.
I was going to say, because that's not him.
That's
right?
Not him. That's another
that's
guy.
That's what threw me off at first. I'm like, hold
yep.
on.
Like, so he goes to this ball and he's standing in front of it. And he goes, he has to absorb all the damage and survive. To save his crew.
Right.
So he throws himself into it. And he's covered
and
in this pool of blood.
There, right. Arms
pool
crossed.
Of blood. On death's door. Standing there for hours. Trying to hold himself from dying. And the other. The second in command. Like after this guy. The cook. Finds him. He goes. What the fuck happened here? He goes. You're dead. You're almost dead. He goes. Nothing happened. And he to this day. Never talked about this moment. Nobody knows but him and that other guy, bro.
That's badass.
Bad fucking ass, bro. This is one of my favorite anime clips today.
What? How far is this into this show?
This is like episode 400.
Okay, so almost halfway through.
Yeah,
yeah.
But this takes a bro. This is such a spectacular moment because it's such self-sacrifice. They never brought it up. The only person that knows is him.
Yeah.
And actually, we found out later that one of the other parts of the crew, a member, the archaeologist, she's a woman. She actually listened and she saw this happen, but she respected his wishes and never told anybody. So there's only three people on the crew that know that this happened. Even the captain never found out.
Yeah.
So they go to the next island. The captain's like, dude, you're fucking dying. Like, what's wrong? You're really weak right now. So yeah, that's what I want to share with you. Just one of my favorite clips.
Is this Japanese?
It's in Japanese, yeah. But you can watch it.
I can't believe I haven't seen more of this shit. I've seen this before. I've seen Kuma. I've seen Bartholomew.
So you know this?
I've seen them before.
How do you know Kuma? What the fuck?
I don't know. That's the same thing, right?
Yeah. How do you know Kuma? Why?
I've seen it before. I think that's the same. I thought that was a different show. I didn't know
One Piece
was
bro.
All like one big thing. So,
how do you know Kuma, bro?
I've seen clips
Bartholomew
before.
Bartholomew Kuma? What the fuck?
Isn't that one of them too?
Yeah, that's him. That's him, yeah.
I thought his name was Zoro.
No, Zoro's the green. Bartholomew is the guy with the pawpaw fruit that pushed the power out. He picked up the captain and made the ball. The big guy standing.
That big thing was Bartholomew?
He was Bartholomew.
Why do Puma. I always see that name then?
Because he's prolific. He's a side character, but he's very, very like a part of the
story.
Yeah,
so I see clips of this shit all the time because I just follow mad shit like that, you know? And especially on my Twitter, like mad people post anime shit and, and manga shit. And, I look at it and I see clips, but I don't. That didn't look as familiar to me as the other ones. But when you say One Piece, I'm like, Kuma. I'm like, that's definitely.
That's so weird that you actually know that name. And that's who that the guy
is that the girl, Kuma?
No. The Kuma was the big guy. The guy that he was standing is like, please, I'm begging you, don't kill my crew. That's Kuma. Kuma is an anti. He's neutral. So he's not good. He's not bad. He does good things. He does bad things.
Okay.
But. Hey, bro, I can sit here and I can
The whole thing. I know. And I'm interested too, so I'll just sit here and just listen to the whole thing. And fans will be like, "What the fuck are we?"
Yeah, I know. One Piece. Let's just put it like this: One Piece is written by a writer. His name is Oda. Oda Echiro. His nickname, we call him Goda. God, because it's Oda. We call him Goda. He is the best writer. One Piece is one of the most spectacular, amazing points of the story. Like. Ever stories ever told, and I've read the Odyssey. I think, bro, I think this is one of the most amazing stories right now.
I don't do the Naruto stories like that for me, so I'm very curious and how
I'm watching Naruto right now,
like again.
Yeah, I started rewatching it. I'm actually halfway through the original series, and then I'm gonna start Shippuden. And I've watched One Piece twice, entirety back to back, and I actually started watching it a third time. One Piece is 1,000 episodes long at this point.
And you do Japanese with English subtitles?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how I did
it. I actually, when I watch, I've been watching it for so many years now, I don't even hear it in Japanese anymore.
Yeah, like, just because of the scene, you know what they're saying and shit.
Well, it's not that I know what they're saying. I just like, I read and I put myself in a trance that it just sounds like I hear what they're saying.
That's what I mean. Like, you know that they're saying this in English, even though they're saying it in Japanese, but you just know.
I'm processing it so quickly that I'm like, so people get bothered. Like, how are you supposed to read and watch at the same time? You practice. I've had a lot of people tell me that, like, Robbie, he doesn't get that. I'm like, you just practice. Yeah. It's like watching a movie with subtitles. But
say, Inglourious Basterds, the movie, 2/3 of that movie is in French and German subtitles.
It's in a different language, exactly. Yes,
and people fucking loved it. I don't get people when they say that all the time, or especially on fucking Netflix. They're like, the whole show's subtitles because it's a Korean show or something. I'm like, what's different than Inglourious Basterds? That's always my prime example. Mm-hmm.
But Zoro's one of my favorite characters of all time. Love Zoro. Looks badass. He's in a world where people have powers and have lineage that are like of kings.
Right.
And he's just a swordsman, bro.
Yeah.
And he has 3 swords and he just whoops ass.
Dude, one other kind of deeper piece on that. Fucking Japanese shows, man. Show writers, the writers in general. Like, every fucking American cartoon you see is so, like, happy ending.
Linear, bro.
There's always, like, protagonist, antagonist, damsel in distress. It's so fucking A-B. Like, every show like this, like, you see people get fucking murdered. People that you loved for the first 300 episodes, like... Right. You're like torn up. Dude, when Sasuke and fucking Itachi, like when they fight,
I'm like, no.
Like, stop it. Like,
you don't want them to fight.
Right. You're like, this is fucked up. Like, but no American shows are that complex. Mm-hmm. They're always fucking ABC. And because of CD happens, like, it's God. Like, I hate it. But yeah, I don't know. That's a whole deep dive, too.
I told you I'm kind of building a universe, but I'm actually taking not inspiration from anime, but I'm taking creative liberty from anime. It's just like, how creative they can be, and they can switch things up on a beat.
Yes.
Like, there are animes where Attack on Titan, season 1 is different from 2, 2 is different from 3, 3 is different from... If you watch every season individually, like, this is a different show.
Yeah. I thought, actually, I watched 2 different shows when I watched, because I watched all of Attack on Titan season 1 and accidentally watched a new season like at some point. And I was like, oh shit, there's another show.
Completely, like, this is, I was like, this is dope.
And then I saw, I was like, oh, they have more seasons. Exactly. I was like, oh fuck.
Yeah, Attack on Titan, the writer for that anime is, I'm going to say he's very, very close to Oda. Like, he, what an amazing story he's told.
I keep seeing, and people are always like, yeah, for all time animes, Full Metal Alchemist is still one of the best. It's like, I don't get what that attraction is. Have you seen that one though? I have, yeah. But
have you seen Brotherhood, the whole thing?
No.
that. So here's the issue: is Fullmetal Alchemist.
They, sorry for the anime segment.
Yeah. I know some people hate it.
Who cares?
Well, who cares? So Fullmetal Alchemist was a manga, and then back in like early 2000s, late 1990s, I believe at the time, they tried adapting it to an anime while the manga was ongoing. But they went so quickly with the anime that it caught up to the manga. And then they had to write story for the anime to keep it going. That wasn't the manga. So there's a point in Fullmetal Alchemist, the original, where it splits and it doesn't make sense. So they actually canceled that and then let the manga finish. And then 3 or 4 years later, they reanimated it from the start. And they're like, okay, no, this is the actual story.
Okay.
So you have to watch Brotherhood's 50 episodes long. The reason it's such a good anime is because it's a spectacular story, a spectacular world.
Story's great.
The English voice acting is better than the Japanese.
Yeah.
That's one you actually watch in English.
So that's what I saw too. And I was like, okay, well, I feel like the people are saying it's like considered an all-time great because America likes it. Like that's Americans saying that. It's
not because fucking... they're blonde hair, blue eyes.
Right.
Yeah, it actually is.
That's
like,
why.
Yeah,
okay. So to me, I was like, Naruto was 10 fucking times better than that show, in my opinion. Because I fucking
but it's
Naruto.
Longer though, which is also a factor. People want to watch
the Naruto.
Naruto's like, bro, Naruto the original is like 200 episodes.
Yeah,
Shippuden's another 400 episodes. Right. So we're talking at least 500-600 episodes for Naruto.
Yeah, and Full Metal Alchemist
50.
That's what I mean. Yeah. Oh, you meant? I thought you meant that Full Metal Alchemist was longer than Naruto. I'm
no,
like, no fucking
shorter,
way.
Way.
Yeah,
shorter.
I was like, how is
it's
that 50. Possible?
That's
yeah.
what I'm saying. Okay. But it's absorbable. You can watch the whole thing.
Good point.
In
yeah.
a week, if you want.
Right.
To. And in a couple days if you wanted to. So.
And like it's not so much going on that like some people with Naruto, like they just start getting lost at one point.
Right.
They're like, there's too many stories. There's too much of this.
They split it up into Naruto's story, Sasuke's story.
Right.
And whatever else
yeah.
at the time.
Yeah.
I totally agree with you. I wouldn't say that Naruto is better than Fullmetal Alchemist. I think they're on the same tier. But Fullmetal Alchemist is a very absorbable world, and it's I think you should watch it.
I did. I've watched Fullmetal Alchemist, but the Brotherhood. Yeah,
Brotherhood.
I watched it when I was young.
Yeah.
And it wasn't in English when I watched it. Mm-hmm. I watched it with English subtitles.
Mm-hmm.
And they weren't good in English subtitles.
Let me tell you about this one that they put out that is really strange because I couldn't identify with it, but it was really good. So I'll just go over it pretty quickly. This is one that recently came out in the last year called Mushoku Tensei. And it's basically, it translates to jobless reincarnation. So it's a fat, ugly, fucking nerd, shut-in weeaboo that in high school, he got bullied. They stripped him naked and tied him to the front gate of the school. And he was there for hours. And they threw shit at him, took pictures of him, like called him names, whatever.
Yeah.
After that, he never recovered. So he shut himself into his room for the next 10 years.
Okay.
Until he was like in his mid-30s.
It's like Old Boy. Jesus.
Old Boy? You seen Old Boy?
Same
That's
kind
a crazy
story.
Movie.
Fuck up.
That's
movie,
a crazy
dude.
Fucking
Movie's
movie.
Dark.
So he actually... he lives as a shut-in. He never recovers. He hates the world. He hates his family. A lot of anger. And then one day he decides, I'm going to go out. I'm going to do it. It's been long enough. I'm going to do it. He walks to the convenience store, and there's a girl in the middle of the street that's going to get hit by a car. And he's like, if anything, my life has been a piece of shit, but maybe if I save this girl, she can redeem it for me. Like maybe whatever. So he runs up, pushes her, gets hit, dies. Reincarnates as a baby in a fantasy world, keeps all his memories, and they're like, the gods, like, I'll give you another chance to reinvent yourself. You can be a mage, you can be a swordsman, you can be whatever.
Okay. Because like you had a shit life. Like, here's this gift. You know?
Here's this gift. Like, he's just a normal kid, like a really like pretty young, like blonde kid. And the problem with the anime, even though I love the anime, it's a great concept, is they keep going back to his fat, ugly version. Like his soul is not the kid. His soul is the fat,
is the original
guy. And he like self-loathes and he's depressed and anxious.
Oh, that kind of sucks though.
But like at the end, he gets out of it. And he actually like, they have this moment where his soul changes and he like reshapes himself. He's like, oh, like I don't have to be that way anymore.
Right.
I'm
like you kind of make your own image of yourself. You don't need,
exactly.
I think that sounds like they're trying to get that point into him.
They get that point
so,
across.
Yeah.
But when they have it, but it's, I think it's like 50 episodes or 25. But when they get to the end is when they finally have that change. The rest of the time, you're like, I don't give a fuck about
this. You're like, all right, let's go.
Like, oh, I don't care.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm going on an anime rant, bro.
No,
there's
I mean,
a lot of good stories out there.
I fucking love it. I don't know who the fuck listens to this, you know? We have no fucking idea. We have
Love the creativity of about anime.
Right.
Let's watch a couple more videos on the strike.
Exactly. We'll wrap up after these. This video is so fucking funny.
Grant a Wish Foundation. Both teams have agreed to come together and have Tommy run the first play of the
game. Oh, yeah.
And there he goes.
I've seen it. I love this shit, bro. So it's like this kid's like make a wish. He wants to run a touchdown on the field. They all agreed. They're giving it. He's running slow as fuck.
Wow.
He's going to make it, bro. He's 30 yards, 20 yards. Get the fuck out of here.
Look,
you're stunting on him, bro. Look,
not moving.
Kid's
not moving.
He's on the ground, bro.
Out cold.
this is a skit. This is fake.
This is from a show, I think, right? Yeah, yeah. It's from like a movie or something, but Jesus.
Yeah, it's like a movie or a show, yeah.
When I saw this... Because this went viral before, like a couple years ago, I think. Mm-hmm. This went viral
a while
ago.
Oh, yeah, this has been viral for years. Yeah, yeah. 5 years, easy.
I didn't know it was fake at that first time, and I...
It looks real, though.
The angle.
Boom, get the fuck out of here, kid,
bro. The fact that it's not great quality, either. The announcer sounds pretty legitimate, so like you're like, wow. I laughed so fucking hard when I first saw this shit, right?
And
I was like...
And then he stunts on him. He's like, right. Get the fuck out of my face, bitch. Oh, you want to talk about VR? We haven't talked about that shit.
Yeah, we can do that right after this.
We'll do an intro and then we'll do the porn review next week.
Okay, we could start off with that next week. Yeah, it'll be our first fucking thing.
Yeah.
All right,
we can do that.
Johnny Depp's finger got cut off. I still can't fucking get that. You know, I don't think it was a pinky. I think it was like an index, but still fucks with me,
bro. Oh yeah, yeah.
We all know what's going to happen in this, but it's still great to watch.
I love this shit, bro. I bought one of these, bro. Bro, destroys their TV.
But like...
embarrassing, bro.
You gotta think, right? Because he literally jumped, no hands out.
Yeah.
Like, he just looked down head first and leaped. Yeah. Like, he legitimately got into it. Like... Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is PlayStation VR. No wonder I was like, what is this?
Yeah, it's a little different. But just the fact that like...
VR is spectacular.
It's amazing.
Let me tell you, bro. I was on Reddit yesterday. And on Reddit, I saw this hentai. Just scroll. And I don't get hentai on my main feed. So I'm like, why is this? It was like... it was an advertisement. But this guy's like, look at how far VR porn has come. And it was like... a hentai VR. And I was like, yo, this shit is good. Good as fuck. Like, you can walk around, like, you can fucking spread the put. I was like, hey, yo.
Wait, you can interact?
Yeah, bro.
With, like, the obstacles in the porn?
Yeah. Dude.
No fucking way.
Yeah, dude. So what? I was like, this shit looks crazy. And I was hold doing on, research, wait, bro.
We might want to save. I want to ask a lot of questions already. Okay, we might want to save this.
You want to save it?
Oh, all right, God.
So we'll tease it. Let's say I ordered it, it's at my house. I'm going to indulge for the next week. And
okay,
we'll
so you haven't used it yet?
It just got here.
Okay.
It just got to my house.
Holy shit, dude. I did not think you could like actually like...
It got crazy.
Interact with things? Yeah. Like what? Like,
bro, if you...
But wait, what if... Wouldn't you want... Okay, we can't... I got so
you
many questions.
You just take one off and...
No, yeah, no, sure. Yeah.
Crazy.
All right,
we're getting there, bro.
One more video. This was hilarious.
I wish we could talk about it. We'll talk next
This
week.
Is hilarious. We're going to talk like for 20 minutes about it.
Was moonlighting as a handyman. He might replace his hook with what?
With a penis.
A hammer.
Try again.
A penis.
A penis.
Tell me the age a kid is.
And he stops. What the fuck did
it's the
say?
Reaction, you
what
know?
The fu- it took
it's
a second.
It's the reaction. That's what it is for this.
And Steve Harvey said, what the fuck did he just say?
We've seen so many of these from this show
that
this point, like, they got old to me at one point. It's like, all right, people are just trying to say dumb shit now.
Yeah.
But for some reason, this one, I was like, yeah, the fact he just kept reading the next one, then he's like, wait a minute.
He's like, I have to go back.
A hammer.
Try again.
A penis.
Tell me the age a kid is too old to sleep with a what
he said. because the tension, it's the comedic timing. He let the tension build
and then he
deflated the balloon.
Right.
You know,
right.
It was really, really good comedic timing.
Also, the face afterwards, the straight face asking the crowd,
accentuated
stopping
by
everything.
What the fuck on a family show? Like, what the fuck did he just say?
Yeah.
Like, that was
That was clean.
That was clean.
Steve Harvey
though.
Picked up a lot of comedic shit in this and yeah, from doing did. This show.
Like, right. Family Feud is probably really big on media right now. But just these clips are keeping it alive.
Oh yeah.
All the sex clips.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro. Like I actually really enjoy them, and there's quite a few of them out there.
Yeah.
Steve Harvey, from what I hear, is not a great person, but he is.
I have heard the
hilarious.
Same.
He is hilarious.
I've heard he's kind of a piece of shit.
Yeah, but who yeah. isn't nowadays? Even I'm a piece of shit, bro.
This video, you know the video when the woman crashes into the car? She's like, oh, shit,
yeah,
I gotta
yeah,
go.
Yeah, let's see. I
you
love
You
want
to watch it?
Yeah. I haven't seen this in a long time. This was on YMH a while ago.
Yeah, wicked long time ago.
Wait, I'm going to show you how to turn up on your b***h. Woo! Damn, I just got an accident, and I got to keep going, so I'm going to call y'all a fuck back. I got to go.
Yeah, I forgot she was.
Yo, this is my spirit animal, dude.
Woo! Damn, I just got an accident, and I got to keep going, so I'm going to call y'all a fuck back. I got to go.
The coherence of constantly staying on topic of the IG video and constantly communicating,
yeah,
like seconds after that happened, yeah. I honestly identify.
She's in
with
shock.
Her.
She just got an adrenaline pump. Yeah, maybe she's on drugs here.
She could be. Yeah, she very well could be.
She could be on drugs. Yeah, because that's the only way that you kind of stay at that level after getting in a car accident.
I'm
because
on. If, oh yeah, after getting in a car accident.
You,
yeah.
Otherwise,
I was
if
like,
you,
I'm
a car, you go
level.
Up. Yeah. You go up, but she stayed. Like, yeah. She was already here and she just stayed there.
Right.
Yeah, no, this lady's tripping. She gets in a car accident, she's driving, yeah. and she just like keeps on going.
So apparently,
the neck tattoos also aren't a great look on her. You can just barely see them in the light.
Is she wearing a shower cap?
Yeah. Oh, are those neck tattoos or is she just black? Oh, no, those aren't even tattoos.
No, yeah, it doesn't look like tattoos, actually.
I thought they were, bro.
It did actually look like it when you first said that. It looked like there's ink there. Right there,
yeah, but I think it's just the lighting. It's
camera
the
lighting and everything. Yeah.
It's a bad camera, bad lighting.
Yeah. I don't know, dude. Manchester's getting worse every day. Since Jake has to drive around there every day, he's fucking constantly gets alerts of all the shit going on with cops and everything, dude. Nearly, it's 2 to 3 times a week. There's shootings and shit. It's That's fucked crazy. Up.
How about Nashville? Bro, I'm moving to Nashville. It's kind of chill.
Yeah, really? I heard Nashville was bad a few years ago, so yeah.
It's not that bad. Bro, the city life in Nashville is huge. Every Saturday, so they have those electric scooters you can rent in Nashville. Mm. There are kids drunk.
Flying, dude, right? Wasted,
but not flying, bro. They actually, like, you get a group of, like, 10 kids, and not kids, like, 20-year-olds.
Right.
Three of them are on scooters. The rest of them are walking. They always walk by my neighborhood. I get a bunch of them.
Yeah.
But they're going to and from the bars, and it's a pretty big scene, so.
Honestly, I see, when I did that in Nashville, I told the story like 50 episodes ago, so I won't again, but me and Jake went on those scooters because we've never been on them before. Besides, Nashville was like the first time, and we were drunk. One, we had a bottle. Like, I just had my bag and I had a bottle in the bag and I was driving around with it. We were shit-faced all fucking day driving around that thing, and I was fucking flying,
bro.
Flying.
Me too. Mike, max speed, bro.
Max speed. Yeah. Like, those things haul ass.
They haul.
I thought
like 10, 15, 20 miles an hour. Maybe.
Yeah. I was like, holy shit. Like, this is almost unnecessary.
I went to
like,
Atlanta, Georgia with Robbie. They had the same scooters there, but much because I don't know why, but it was a way bigger system. Mm. Way more scooters than I've normally seen.
Oh, okay.
They were everywhere.
Yeah.
And hauling ass. Go fast. Yeah. Did I ever tell you the time a fucking crack? I'm going to call him a crackhead. A crackhead chased me on a scooter.
I think so. I don't know if we talked about it on the podcast.
It's a quick story. I'll go pretty quick. Yeah. I fucking love it, bro. I'm in Atlanta, Georgia. I'm on a scooter. We're going to the club or from the club. I don't remember. But it's out. It's like midnight, 1 in the morning. And I'm dressed nicely, bro. I'm out by myself. I think Robbie's doing whatever the fuck he's doing. I'm just driving. I'm on the scooter. And I drive by this black dude. He's like, yo, I got bud. Let me know. And I stop. I'm like, hey, yo, you got weed, bro? Because I just had my weed pen.
Right.
So I'm like, I could fuck with some flowers. Like, all right. So he's like, yeah, I got weed. Now, let me show you, bro. And he turns around and comes back and pulls out this stack of bags. And they're Nick bags. Not even that. They're Nick bags.
Really?
Nick bags with a little bit of weed. He goes, yep, $20 a piece. I'm like, $20. I'm like, that's a Nick, bro.
Yeah, right.
And he's like, what do you mean, bro? No, that's $20 a dub, bro.
Yeah.
I'm like, nah, bro.
They pull a scale out right now.
I'm like, that's a Nick. I'm not giving you $20 for that.
Right.
And he's like, I'm like, nah, bro. I know my weed. I'm all set. And he's like, no. And he's like, all right. Like, I won't try to scam you. I'll give you the real weed. And he's like, pulling out other shit. And like, this guy had crazy, like, he was probably drunk. He had crazy eyes. Middle of the night, it was just me and him. I'm like, I'm not trying to get robbed.
Yeah.
So I'm like, nah, bro, I'm all set. I'm good. I'm like, I'm good. I appreciate it, fam, but I'm all set. He already alienated me. I started riding away. He was like, nah, bro, I got you, bro. My bad. Like, I got you with the real shit, bro.
Right.
And I was like, I'm good, bro. Fam, please leave me alone. Yeah. I start riding away. And I hear something behind me after like 10, 15 seconds, and I turn around. He's behind me, riding behind me.
I'm like, what the fuck? So I speed up. He starts speeding up crazy like this, bro.
Yeah.
Crazy fucking eyes. He's like, no, I got you, bro. I got you, bro. Just come back.
Jesus.
And I guess when I turned around, I had a look of fear, Max. I was like, hey, yo, don't fucking chase me anymore, dog. And I was like,
right. Like, yeah.
Cause he checked himself. He's like, oh no, my bad, bro.
Right. He probably didn't even like think. He probably was fucked up, right?
He was fucked
up. So he's like rolling or something.
But you could see that he was like, oh my, like he didn't mean to do that to me. So I kind of felt bad after.
Yeah.
He was like, my bad, bro. I didn't mean to do that.
You know what I think? MDMA, because that does that. You kind of bug out a little bit in the eyes.
So,
yeah, and your eyes will sometimes shake even too.
Oh, so, shit.
Yeah, I think he was rolling and he's like, whew, having fun? I'm going to sell something to this kid?
Yeah.
And then when you, like, he saw fear in you, he's like,
he's like, no! I didn't do that, bro.
Because when you're on MDMA or ecstasy and like someone says they're like uncomfortable with you, like you take it to heart.
Oh,
you take
real?
It personal.
You could see the pain in his face.
Yeah.
I saw the pain in his face.
Yeah.
And that's why I felt remorseful that he felt remorseful. I was like,
dude,
I was like, okay, you're not a bad dude. You're just like.
I was at a party once and I stubbed a girl's toe when I didn't stub it. I stepped on her toe because we were all rolling dick. And I was rolling so hard and that when she got a little upset, she's like, oh God, my toe. And I started crying. I was like, I'm so sorry. It was intense, dude. But I was like,
I feel better then.
Yeah, I was geeking. I was like,
oh, really?
Just walking around. I was like,
so this was probably on like ecstasy or something.
That was like more than ecstasy, I think. That shit was cut with something.
Maybe.
I was fucking losing my mind.
You're tripping, huh?
Yeah, last video and we're good.
One more? All right.
Oh no!
What are you doing out here? Eating what?
Yeah.
Bro.
To bury all those guys in the
for
dark.
For the video, too. This is all for a fucking video.
Yeah. It took them hours to do that.
Hours to fucking
do
it.
That, bro.
I'd say to get them all buried takes around an hour to 2 hours alone because you have
to build. Well, they're not all the way down. They're sitting up. So
right.
They're sat up, so they only have to go down 3 feet. So I get, 15, 20 minutes a hole? There are 1, 2, 3,
dude,
4,
like
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I think there was one in the back. There were like 19 people there.
Right, right.
Maybe 20.
Yeah.
Maybe even 20. Bro, we can count them. There are like there are 20 kids there, bro.
I'd say there's a safe 20 there.
There's a safe 20
I'd
there,
say,
bro.
Honestly.
Yeah.
Good video, still.
Good video.
I feel like, honestly, why not, you know?
Very dangerous.
I mean, 22,000 likes, probably not a shit ton of views.
This is a repost. I've seen this.
Okay, I was going to say.
These are not the original guys.
I don't know what they, like, this is strictly for clout, right? They're not promoting anything.
No,
this
is just meme. This is just meme.
Not really a great joke or anything.
This is just like college students going out, getting drunk and like, yo.
I don't even think that's college. These kids look younger.
Yeah, maybe high school. Maybe elementary or something.
I don't know. Yeah, those kids, they just have wicked tiny heads. So I'd imagine that, unless it's the camera, but he might be a little older. Look at some of these kids, you know? Those are puny fucking heads.
That's why I'm saying college, because that kid sitting in the chair looks like a young man. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Look at him.
Maybe.
Look at his face.
He's just an older brother beating on his younger
Could
brother's
be.
Friends.
Could be.
Bury yourself.
He actually looks pretty young. There's no facial hair.
Yeah.
He looks pretty young, actually.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, let's get the fuck out of here. We had a fucking great ass episode.
All right, this is us coming back to the Brutal View. Sorry we've been gone. We're back.
Yeah.
We're going to be dropping more shorts. If you're new and you're listening to us, we appreciate you.
Well, yes.
Because of the shorts, I'm sure we're going to get some new listeners and they're going to go to the newest episodes.
Right, right.
So thank you for tuning in. If anyone has gotten this far, anybody,
yes.
One person, drop a comment in the video, wherever the fuck, if you're not on YouTube, go to Brute's Instagram and drop a comment on his latest shit. And what do you want them to say? Falafel. Say falafel.
No, say Krill Smith.
Say Krill Smith.
Say Krill Smith.
Krill Smith.
Say Krill
if you
Smith.
Say Krill Smith in the comment section, just that alone, nothing else.
Right.
We're gonna message you. You can either come on a podcast or we'll send you some kind of gift.
Yeah.
If one person has gone, I will buy you a $10 gift.
I wouldn't say we want to buy a gift yet. We'd start with a podcast. Let's see how
you
want to
shout
goes.
Them out.
Yeah,
we'll shout you out.
We'll start with we can either shout you out.
I'll buy you a $10.
And
I'll
honestly,
suck your dick.
You show something more.
I'll suck your dick.
We can call. You know.
I'm just assuming it's a guy.
603-922-4074.
Job.
And we'll talk for a few minutes on the podcast. Maybe as a Patreon, but then we'll release it at some point, you know, stuff like that.
I want to see. You think anyone, this is 2 hours long. Maybe it's all at hour 45 at the end of the day.
Yeah, I probably have to cut maybe 5 minutes from this, I'd say. Yeah. I don't think I have to cut too much. Mm-hmm. I think when we were talking about the shorts calling it like faggots and shit, we probably have to cut a bunch of that.
A little bit of that out. Or mute it, because it was kind of funny.
It was pretty funny. Yeah, Should I leave it?
mute it.
I mean, I was quoting someone else, so I mean.
Yeah.
Either way, yes, thank you for tuning in. So last week I did say this, but if you are newer, 603-922-4074, anything about the episode, comment, drop, send us a text, tell us a story.
Anything.
If you relate to anything in the episode or if you have something to add to anything to the episode, let us know. The shorts will be going at about once every 2 weeks, maybe a little more. I need to find good ones. A lot of the old ones we have are, one, pretty shitty quality just because we didn't really have a great setup down yet.
Sure.
A lot of cross, like, multicam things.
Yeah.
That's why it always looks so small in the shorts.
Right.
And a lot of them, there's music in them. And I can't remove it unless I, like, re-edit those videos type of thing.
So a lot of new content, really.
A lot of new content.
Which is fine.
Dropping.
This is a great episode. We're going to get a couple clips from this and a couple of the last ones, and we'll take it from there. So, if there are any new listeners or any listeners at all, thank you.
Yes.
Come back.
We'll have much more. Check out the gaming. Check out my music. Check out Splich in general.
Yeah, pretty much.
Just look at him.
Just look at me.
We'll be back next week.
We'll be back. Thanks for tuning in.
Happy Easter.